I don't even remember what I was just talking about.
Might be good.
Oh, you got a delay. If you refresh, it should be at the same time.
Yes.
Really, oh yeah, the four aces hand. Anyway, he bet the river, got re-raised, I think it was, and he then, I knew it, he was going to re-raise again. And he did, because he proudly wanted to stand up and turn over the bluff with four aces.
I think
he risked about €28,000 to do it. But when money means nothing, what does it matter?
Yin? Ah, Yin. Billy.
Billy. Billy, put the bank for you. Billy, put the bank for you. What is that? Boss， 郭青在找你啊。
Not a bad flop for Bojang. Three pairs, cut shot, and a pair and a gut shot for Jan Peter. This must go. He's got backdoor diamonds, and a lot of people say backdoor diamonds. Not for me. On this board, Ace King 7-5 is going in the bin for me. If Bojang checks, then Jachtamann could lead the river. Well, Jachtamann can win this pot right now. Well, maybe not now, because it's come a gin card for Bojang. It's a card that may call him. Just check behind. There's no value betting here. Not to me. The only reason you'd bet here is to get like a 5 highs, 8 high flush to fold. Which we know, if they're calling with 2 pairs of straights, they're never folding flushes.
2 pair wins.
I
was so sad today. My little boy had to have a little thing done to him in the hospital, and I wanted to be there. My wife's sending me pictures now. This one we want to see. Needles in his arm. Oh. Very strange experience to have a child for me. It's my first. All my friends told me life changes when you have a baby. I didn't believe them. I thought, not me. But it has. And probably for the better, let's say. Yes, but Hougaard.
Yeah, I remember
10-15 years ago playing with Jesper. 10 years ago, when DTD opened, so it must have been 10 years ago.
I'm not over the chair, so it's not my fault.
Yep, I am indeed. Daddy. I'm going to be a super dad. Lucky I had a boy, that's all I know. If I had a girl, she would be in a... Oh, I say in a basement, that probably sounds a bit wrong. She'd be locked up until she's 21. Little baby boy. In fact, I was talking yesterday with Max, because he also, last time we saw each other, his wife was pregnant. She had to go home as he went off to Barcelona. And I asked him what he called his boy, and he said Eli. I thought he was joking, because that's the same name that I chose. So both got a boy called Eli. I don't know anyone else that's got a child called Eli. And all of a sudden, there's two of us. Let's hope it's lucky for both of them and both of us. Yeah, the fun's just begun. He was he's still in the hospital, unfortunately. Or fortunately, depends what way we look at it. So I say fortunately because he's in the best place. He was a little bit early. Quite a bit early. But he's doing good. He's putting weight on. You can see, you can hear, he's got 10 fingers, 10 toes. He's aware of who I am. I'm there every day to see him. And hopefully he should be home within the next 4 to 5 weeks. And that's when the fun begins. Oggy flops the nuts with the straight flush draw. And he's got Kaiser. No, he doesn't. He has Mad betting out with like a bottom end rat, basically. So this is Mad and Kaiser in the pot. Kaiser checks. It's paired the board. Now you've got a queen in your hand as well as the nut flush, so I'd like to see a little check back here. Because there's not much your opponent can have here except the bad flush. Or jacks. So you're not really going to get any action unless it's from jacks. There you go. Yeah, Zach's, my first cousin's called Zach, so we can't. My nephew's called Ziggy, so I'd like to have had like maybe Zach. I wanted to call him Zidane. Zinedine Zidane Zimbler. That would be the spumma. The easy. Eli Zimbler. EZ. Easy. It was another name with Z we were looking at. Thanks very much, Hog. And could you just send the money that I lost to you back? I need it back now. Oh, Mr. Beavers, good morning. Joe Beavers, the old Hendon mob. Stuck. He's there in the chat box. I think we should have Joe here with us. We need to get Joe in as a co-commentator. Next time, I'm going to make a suggestion, but they'll probably boot me out. Yeah. Get Joe in the game, I promise you, I'm sure he'd like to be in this game. Looking at the lineup. I tell you what, in this game, I think Joe's VPIP might be a bit more. This is a good action game we've got today. Yeah. It got really interesting last night, actually, towards the end of the day. And I can tell you that game did move tables. The last hand of the night, we had Scotty and Jonas in a pot, and Jonas folded, and we thought he folded, so he didn't just donate €4,000 towards the, for the last hand of the night, and he was going to take his profit and go to bed. He did continue in the game. Not sure what time that went on to. I needed to get some sleep. So that must have been like 10 years ago. 9, 10 years ago, Hog? Bonav, we've got Texas Hold'em in about 4 hours, sir. We've got a quick session of PLO. Let these players spin up some cash. And then later on tonight, Livbury is coming into the building. Igor is going to be here. Obviously, they're together. They'll be together. We've got No Limit Hold'em starting at about 8:30 p.m.
No, that's a very different situation.
That's why when they have the table, everybody's supposed to point. So
Vinny and Maxi need to be independent.
No, there was no deuce to seven last night.
When Maxi said, you're flush.
Yeah,
We needed a bit of action last night. Started off quite good.
And you throw and you just
got a bit slow in the middle, but then it kind of picked up towards the end.
No,
and our man Max went from 30,000 in the hole to 30,000 in front in the last kind of hour.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. That's different.
Something wrong with the sound. Sorry, I don't know. Try refreshing or just turn off and turn on again. You've got an echo. I don't hear it on my side. Is that any better? No, it's no better. Don't know what to say. I'm not. I've tried all the buttons. Is that clear now? Because that's just me.
Yes, how's the pre-workout stuff feeling right now?
Yeah.
And then we've got the table talk. So I lift up the microphone so we can hear the players at the table.
I don't think it's good for my brain.
Lovely suicidal music in the background.
I knew I should do it like as a first time today. I would have been like so handsome.
I think it would be even worse for you, to be honest.
I might want to try it tomorrow, but then we have...
That's right, Hogs and Kits, that was 10 years ago. You're going to qualify for the next Caribbean adventure they're doing at Dusk Till Dawn. They've just released that. We're going in November to the Hard Rock in Punta Cana. Very excited about that family holiday for me.
You did pass the white animal. You did pass the white animal.
We did have fun in St. Kitts, Hog.
Beauty.
That was a very fun trip. Feels like it was another lifetime ago. Well, these two guys are all in. Queens and tens for Jachtamann against two pair holds. He had queens and tens. He also had the flush draw. Jan Peter. He's not having a good session. Now Jan Peter Jachtamann. Capable of losing 50,000, capable of winning 100.
He's got a feeling or something about this hand, and you check it out on YouTube and then you find out. I can give you the details.
Who got wrong? Did Dimitri lose out or who lost out?
I think nobody is really wrong. It's just Dimitri singing.
Thanks, Jules. We're here for a good time.
Yeah. He wasn't
this is fun. If you want to join in, to see a few more viewers now.
Okay.
We've got competitions that we give loads of stuff away, so feel free to join in. All you've got to do is send me a tweet.
Yes, I don't think I can.
Yeah, I think they're talking about a hand where there was a hand where the pot was awarded wrongly, and it was on the stream, but something they can remember. Sometimes the RFID cards
a lot depends on who it was.
Might not be correct.
With Dimitri, I actually might.
Yeah, but you never know anything. The opposite.
Oh, that's why I would do it with the Dimitri, maybe. I hate this
kind of. And also, if someone's been awarded the wrong money, once the hand's finished and the next hand's dealt, technically there's nothing you can do. It's up to the person. And the problem is if it's on the stream and then you go, we've seen the cards, what if one of the readers of the cards wasn't correct?
For sure, you can never know.
Can happen, but everybody's different. That's what they're talking about. So to get a goodie bag, what do you have to do? Send me a tweet at Paul Zimbler, PaulZimbler, and just tell us how much the biggest pot of the day will be. Nearest guess wins a goodie bag. 50-100, PLO. Ochran, I'm not allowed to say that way round. Thank you, Salomon. There we go. I've spelt it for you. Free to enter. Hoodies, T-shirts, hats, card guards, T-shirts. All sorts of goodies from the King's Casino. In fact, their hoodies, I think they're the nicest hoodies of all of the companies out there. Very comfortable, nice material. They look good. Zip up pockets, open pockets. Everything you need in a hoodie. Barney would love this table, absolutely. Jan Peter Jachtamann there. He's got a fan just come on, ask for his autograph. £10,000 autograph. €10,000.
Oh, but I don't think it's bad etiquette to point out when you have this.
If it's tabled, it's not bad etiquette, but if they're sitting like this and they didn't put it in, then it's very bad.
No, but I wouldn't take offense if you point out when you have it's tabled from anyone against me.
But if someone is sitting like this with their hand,
yeah, and sure. Then I think it's not that's not fair.
Happened to me in Australia, 18k pot. No, a guy is like about to mug, and the other guy goes, no, wait.
Yeah, well, but in Australia they don't know any better.
$400.
Yeah, in about 3.5 hours, it's going to take an hour's dinner break. We'll be switching to No Limit Hold'em. I think they should do the Hold'em first and the Omaha later, because then the sick action can continue through into the night. But they've chosen the Omaha first. Let the action junkies wake up early. I do have confirmation of the lineup tonight. That's what I've just been sorting out. I'll get that on the screen. Well, it's the ace blocker. They call it the bear ace. Kaiser doesn't have much. Interesting that it's opted to lead out. Now, this is a spot where Mads can raise. If a player bets out when you've got the nut blocker, it's an easy spot to raise, but the problem is if they do have the king flush and they don't fold. Don't know if I'm mad about this call, because Wow, now the king's come. That's such a perfect card. Now he's got the ace. The king's on the board, so he could have only now led out with a queen or a jack high flush. Could have been like jacks with a jack high flush. He's got to find a barrel. Well, he's got two pair, I suppose. He does have showdown, but I'd really love to see what the bear ace is going to do.
No, maybe now and in a few minutes. Don't play, so we started 5:15. I think I went to switch. Ah, okay.
Yes, for Hougaard, having a look. He has checked. What Mad's going to do? Today, we have Oggy for the Omaha. We can see Oggy's at the table now playing the Hold'em. Liv Bury, Quirin Zek, Igor, Besim Hot, we saw him yesterday, Sharam, Martin Cabril, and Roman Herald. They are confirmed so far for the Hold'em game that will begin on the stream at 9 p.m. Looks like about 4k. Nice bet. We know that should get through. See, a queen flush would bet this river too. Now the king's hit. Probably bet for value. Kings and nines. Can't check call with two pair on this board. No chance. Not if you've got any respect for money. Let's get this game going. I've never seen Ronny Kaiser play before, I don't think. So it'll be good. Nice. I was a little surprised yesterday at watching some of these world-class tournament players playing cash. Just goes to show you it's a completely different game. And it doesn't matter how good a player you are, if you're playing cash and you maybe are out of your comfort zone, out of your bankroll zone, it shows. And there you go. That is poker for you. But I'm glad Max won a nice chunk. I think he's a good guy. Great for the game. And today, we've got a couple of players here more than capable of several reloads. More than capable of getting it all in with pairs and draws. That's why we love Omaha. We're sick. And I like this Kaiser. He's not afraid to bet certain situations. Nice to bet the draws. Bojang has got the nut flush draw.
It's just the top life being your highest half end, right?
And the truth is, that's it, because even though he's got aces, those aces are kind of irrelevant on this board.
But long time ago.
So he doesn't want to call that size bet.
I was actually.
Not in our
generation. Yes, in my generation.
Hog, are you from the UK?
We had very big success.
Were you there with the DTD, or were you with. I think it was Sun Poker at the time, had quite a lot of people in the same
place.
Not even
we haven't won any title, not even the cup, since 87. Sorry to rub it in. That's 87 is the last time.
I was born 88. I'm from Hamburg too. Maybe that's why I'm not a fan.
But we had title 79, 80, 82, and 83 we had this, like, which is now Champions League. The cup of the...
Yeah, the winners.
It was before the Champions League.
The thing is, though, as a German team, as long as you just, if you can make it in the top 5-6 and qualify for Europe, then you have a good chance to win the European.
Oh, yeah, they had a couple of good shots. made a semi-finals twice in a row.
Yeah. Twice on the UEFA Cup or
these are nice hands.
These
are the kind of hands you want. Four working cards. You know, I mean, if that was the Jack of Diamonds or the Nine of Diamonds, would be a lot nicer.
I mean,
Queen Jack 10-9.
Who just won?
Kaiser's got the blockers here. They say the blockers, so you'd need an 8 really to make a straight in this hand, and he's got 2 of them. People always forget this 4 in the deck. Sometimes get a bit carried away betting 2 of the blockers.
More modern new stadium
now too. No, I have to say they just modernized it.
Yeah, but the
it's a nice bet there.
Because I remember it was like an arena, and it was all terraces, and it was very different. Okay. Now they have 30,000.
Yeah,
they had the old time.
80,000.
Yeah, 89. It looked like a real old.
Yeah, William Hill. They used to have all the lucky players.
Historic.
Funny that they brought in 95% of the revenue, and they had all the winning players.
It's not the same.
It's
not a modern
arena.
Oh, they have you go up to DTD, you support them.
With the skull,
you play on ping
kind of
you've got to win your seat to the Caribbean in November. I think the package is $8,000. It's flight for 2 people, hotel room, all inclusive for 2 people, and 1 entry to their main event. Satellite start, I believe. If not today, next week. Will Liv be playing topless? I think you can answer that question yourself. Bit of a silly question, let's be honest. Teja Vu, welcome. We are just streaming the PLO for 4 hours. We'll be doing the No Limit Hold'em this evening. So many people loving the PLO though. Well, Bojang looks like he's been the aggressor in this pot. He just needs to fire again and he's won it. Yeah, that should be that. Should be the end of that. Paired ball with 2 hearts out there. He can't be chasing straight. Well, I hope to see you there, Hog.
I didn't know who you were talking about. But the way you described that player seems
very. There's more action in PLO. Well, it depends who's playing the Hold'em, to be honest. The perfect lineup would be Bessim in Hold'em, which is Bessim Hot. Leon, obviously. Scotty Hanna. I kind of liked Alex Tomovic because he played solid, and if he loses a hand, he can go a bit giddy. I believe there's a few other big high rollers in the house. Hans Olymp is here. Rene.
You slept in the casino.
They do have some side events running. So if you're in the building, or if you're close, or within a driving distance, and you fancy a game this evening at 7 o'clock, they have the Deep Stack Special. €62 plus 7 euro buy-in. €10,000, the guarantee. 20,000 chips, 2 re-entries available. And 20-minute blinds.
Nobody can hit your person.
So €10,000 guarantee for a €70 comp. Got a feeling there could be an overlay.
Now I know who you mean.
Yeah.
But he's taking it well. He doesn't take it personally.
No, he's taking it well. That's what I mean.
He's just
angry for himself, and I like that one first.
He plays so different. First he plays very tight. If he comes here the first night.
Yeah.
And later, as long as he's behind, then it's starting like, really playing.
Look at that, aces in the small blind.
Yeah. Well,
one
that's
suit.
That's also okay to do now and then.
1,200.
Pumped it up.
A good game.
I'm not a mad fan myself.
Well, it seems weird that you guys are talking about Thomas when he's sitting right there
in the position.
It's good.
Always Thomas.
Yeah. In action games.
Take it personally.
If you get two callers, there's probably no ace left in the deck. And you also kind of open up your hand a bit. You're raising out a small blind. As it happens, this is pretty decent flop for him. He's got a queen in his hand. It's a rainbow board. Unless his opponent was playing with like 8-7, 6-5 and stuff like that. Which, let's be honest, if Bojang had that kind of hand on the button, he would have been raising it up. If I don't talk when they're talking, I'll go home.
Well, I'm
Jan Peter Jachtamann's at the table.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, it's the first time I'm trying. If I get it.
I slept there like 2 years, 2013 and
14. Which hotel?
Vidar.
Ah, well, when the first year was built, I didn't think it was that good.
If I remember, it was
I'm
like
staying
2000
in
Encore and
area, like half.
I like it. Like how's area? It's good.
It's perfect. I don't like the beds. So soft.
Yeah.
It's so beds.
I only tried signature.
I mean, I work there, but they just dance or something.
It's windy this afternoon. I might just take the lunch.
This year, Neuer has a different price.
I'm trying to inform myself, but he said he's not going to be able to play 25.
We need some medium cards to come.
I didn't check the mail, just saw 25% based on this card. I think they have some poker.
No, there's not much action in his hand.
Yeah, but I'm playing the 60s.
I think the poker ride is more expensive this year than it was last year.
It's more expensive. Larger.
Yeah, at least I know for sure an area.
Well, what is the area? What did they charge last year?
Now it is one 150 for weekdays and 220 on the weekend.
First pot. That's actually very reasonable.
First
area, I think is really
expensive. No, but before that, you paid only like 100 and 150.
Okay,
that's they changed it half a year ago. And I think they changed it from 100 to, but I'm not sure exactly what the rates are.
I think Aria is probably the one that I
Aria is a good hotel, yeah.
We're talking about Vegas.
It's very expensive.
Of course, the WFOP is coming up shortly.
Anyway.
Everyone planning their trips.
It's the same price almost.
Yeah. I sleep like 2-3 hours.
You think they have all the same beds there? Every room? Maybe you ask for the for some kind of different.
I think I ask.
Yeah?
I think Vidara is about 150 a night, every night. If you
make
a long
500 for 28 days, I'm pretty sure.
Bobby, for you, every bed is soft because you're so heavy. Should sleep on the floor.
That's very relevant.
Just take a mattress on the floor.
And these guys, like last year, they're flying straight off to Monte Carlo from here on Wednesday. They play the high roller 50,000, the super high roller 100,000, the main event for the EPT.
I mean, I'm definitely gonna stay below the area because I'm gonna play so. Last time I was very late, so there was no room. I got signature, but I actually find it really well too.
I booked signature this year.
Did it? Yeah, it's actually great.
I mean, it's good for long-term rentals. They have kitchen and stuff.
Only you have to take a cab every day, but it's like
but I'm going to the Rio anyway, so I need a cab.
Yeah, there's a cab.
Yeah, you did from the Rio.
Well, this card slows a lot of the action. Well, if he has to check all the flop, he might represent this heart on the river.
It's called like it belongs to MGM.
He's pretty sure he can't.
Signature tower.
He's good with two pair, but he decided to check.
Yeah,
they're going to win the pot.
A little bit more expensive, but it's
that face doesn't look like a man that's now going to bet.
Two pair.
He's checked. Jesper will pick up the
1,400
euro.
What?
109.
The 21 hands in.
Yeah,
two reloads
like
so far.
Yeah, I'm going to be gambling.
From Jan Peter Jachtamann.
it's
not too late to join in. Send me a tweet at Paul Zimblow. What's good, the biggest pot of the night? We're giving away a goodie bag. Kings have got loads of merchandise, and we're allowed to give it away. Hoodies, t-shirts, caps, card protectors. You name it, we've got it. We're giving them away to you guys. My guess, €56,000. I'd love it to be over 100, but I don't think the game's going to be big enough today.
Don't want the 10p, I want the 25p.
I remember playing late night poker.
In
fact, I'm bringing it back. I'm not bringing back late night poker, but I'm bringing back the format. We're doing it at dusk till dawn. We're doing the first one in May. If you want to play a £1,000 shootout, send me a message.
I'm feeling I'm doubling up.
We're going to get bigger as the year goes on. We're even going to have bounty shootouts. But shootout at dawn is going to be coming to your screens soon. Care of myself. Unfortunately, I won't be playing because I'll be working. But hopefully towards the end of the year, once it's all running smooth, I can jump in with the bigger ones. Mookie, they're playing for 4 hours today. We've been going roughly for an hour. So we've got about 3 hours left today on the stream for Omaha. We'll then be taking a little dinner break for an hour and setting up the table. I say setting up, just changing the players for No Limit Hold'em. 50, 100, No Limit Hold'em. Yes, I remember the hand well. I bluffed him, he rebluffed me back.
What's the double up?
He had Jack 9, I had Jack 10. It was a double paired ace board. I remember. If only I knew John how he played, I could have just moved in. Easy to say.
This pot.
I hope so. I hope we get some guests in today.
It's
not the easiest thing in the world to do by yourself for 9 hours. We'll give it a bash. Liv will always come in if she's not playing. She's arrived today. She's set to play this evening. Mookie, you've got to send me a tweet, unfortunately, because if everybody writes it down in the chat box, I won't be able to go back and check the winning answer. John Duffy, I see him quite a bit, doing very well for himself. Plays in a few very high stakes games. I think he's busy with work. Such a lovely guy as well. A really nice guy, John. John also helped change poker on TV. The creator of the European Poker Tour.
I'm not proud of myself.
What a good job he did.
$650.
Discount. Oh. I know, Mookie. I tell you what, I'll make one exception for you.
Easy.
Just send me a tweet if that's the biggest pot. That's the easiest thing to do. Six is afraid of seven because 7, 8, 9. The bottom straight for Kaiser. Nothing for Jachtamann, but will that stop him? Only he can answer. And you can see that badge he's wearing. Hocker Poker. That's his website. If you're German, if you speak German, check it out. HOCHGEPOKERT. And then I remember in late night poker, Vicky. I think her name was Vicky Lincoln. I think she used to be with Alan Abrahams. Took me out, my ace king against ace nine or something.
Oh,
wow. So yeah, it's solid play folding hands. You think king, queen, ten kind of hands. People play those a lot. But this is a nice hand. Jack, double ten, eight. It's not too bad a hand. Yeah, king, queen, 10-6 was rainbow. A lot of players would get involved. It's a solid, disciplined fold.
Maximum.
Jan Peter Jachtamann raising it up. the small blind. So we can only assume he definitely should have four working cards. He's probably either got aces or kings in his hand. With a suit, one or the other. Oh, he's only got three of them. He's probably upset he doesn't have four, but he could tell us the story after this hand about when he had four. Nothing worse than having three aces in your hand and none of them are suited. Well, two callers. Now, from the blind, when you've got three aces in your hand, you know there's been a raise, and if you three bet, you're going to get called. There's probably no ace left in the deck to hit, so now all you're looking to catch is your one flush draw, and he's blessed that he's found it on a board where he's probably not going to get much action, but he's built a big enough pot that he can bet pot and hopefully take this down. Shouldn't face any resistance. An overpair for Hougaard is not going to get involved.
Good.
Here they come. Turn them over. He's going to say, one, two, three.
That's the most clear.
Incredible against this English guy who folds the trips at the turn. This was funny. He's saying, he might have a flush, but I don't want to see the river. I don't want to candy. You know, this was really sick. I was happy for that. I could have been drawing dead, I just re-raised him, and he folds it.
Folding around just the blinds.
Drawing death?
Yeah, going upstairs.
Not
many hands that Bojang isn't going to defend with.
It's a fun story as well with the
He's 3 bet, 900.
If he had a full house, I was, let's say, I was representing a really nut flush.
Well, this could give a bit of action. It's a gut shot and a flush draw with a pair for Kaiser. With a gut shot, flush draw, and a pair. And over pair with a bare ace of clubs.
Yes, for sure. I was hoping not that he had three. And then I was sure.
I agree, Mookie. You should write a really bad letter and send it to him as a draft and see if he approved it.
Anyway, but if he just calls, I think I just let it go.
Just checking how much he's got behind.
The funny thing is, if he calls, bet 1200. Chase his full house and you shove him off on the river, it's an even better play. But requires also a big performance.
Kaiser.
Yes, but I was sure if he calls the chair.
Could check raise this flop. It's possible. Unlikely. More likely just to check call, see the turn. Yeah, he had pumped it up though. Action.
That situation was surprised.
I should like that.
1, 3, 4.
Gets it through. If that does happen, just push the old refresh. It's all good, my end.
Drei Spieler. Ich finde, er hat sich immer mit der Gespannung.
He's in the zone.
No, it's just asking you if you like the music, but it looks like.
Nowadays I would be brave enough.
Yeah.
Well, sorry about that. I was just getting the problems fixed for you.
Again,
into Jachtamann. Flops the nuts.
Achso.
Ehrlich, und sofort.
Kailin.
Danke, tschüss.
With a set. Nein.
Weiß ich nicht.
Diesmal keine Nuts. Nein, nein, glaube ich nicht.
And he needs the 9 for a split pot.
Du auch set?
Weiß ich nicht. Du weißt.
Jachtamann has just told him that he's got the nuts.
Weiß ich nicht. Weiß ich nicht.
Not really sure why he's done that. Problem is now, if Kai Lin calls him and hits his card, he's not going to get paid. So he's getting 2-1 when he's a 4-1 shot. That is what they call bad math. If I flipped a coin with you and said if it's heads I give you £5, if it's tails you give me 10, you're not going to flip the coin, are you? But Kai Lin just flipped that coin. He could make a huge bluff, but it's unlikely. He knows Jan Peter will call. Well, I don't like that bet from Jan Peter. Why wouldn't he just bet 3,000? Try and get some money. If Kai Lin took half an hour to call on the turn, he's definitely not going to give you 7,000 on the river.
Warte mal, ich muss zeigen. Ich muss zeigen, meine Blocker.
Yeah, we got the flickering sorted now, I think. Yeah, I've got the lineup for you for this evening. No limit hold'em. That's the game. 50, 100 are the blinds. Confirmed for seats this evening. We have Oggy, the gentleman so we have in 6-7 at the moment. Livbury, Quirin Zech, Igor, Besim Hot, Sharam, Martin Cabril, and Roman Herald. So that's the lineup for this evening.
If
could be a couple
terms,
of changes,
I mean,
we don't know.
Seems really fair. Let's just start the round after I did this one, yeah? That's what you're saying.
So I think they're talking about a round of straddles.
Very good spot.
Thank you, Omaha Kings.
The race is already too big, so
it's a very good spot.
I read a quick book on Omaha before I turned up. It says if all your cards don't add up to 21, fold. That's a lie, because you want 5-5-4-3. 7-6 pair and an up and down for Oggy. Not much else really. 10 of clubs on the turn brings all sorts of gut shots. No one with a flush. Oh yeah, one person with a flush draw. Oggy makes his hand even better. In a six-way coup, to be a 75% favourite is like, I reckon, 1,000-1 shot. I'm not very good with odds, but I just took a stab. Very unlikely to be 75% favourite six-handed on a turn in pot limit Omaha. And the more people that fold, you can see his odds actually go down. But if we get heads up, they'll go up. There you go. Now you see them going up. 85%. Wow, the 8 came. It's a little bit scary. But I can't imagine Oggy is going to fold. Should just be check and let Jan Peter have a stab and just call it off. very well played by Oggy. Just a snap call. I mean, you can't fault this. If your man's got nine jack, good luck to him. It's a bit of a nit call, this nit roll. Unless he was thinking of raising, but there's no value in raising.
There it is.
Yeah, Peter Yachtamann will say, give him the money. It's four card pot limit Omaha. And they call it PLO for short. It's played, we're only playing four cards today, but people play four card, five card, six card. If you like to play Omaha, I wouldn't recommend you play six cards. I know it's a lot more gambling, but you give the fish a bigger edge in the more cards you give them. They're happy to gamble in four card, maybe compromise at five. Once you go six card, it's a giddy game. And your edge becomes a lot less. He's not even in his chair, he's collecting money. There you see in the foreground. Tarkin, the floor man for this game, poker manager. Ace, king, queen, jack, double suited. Thomas Bichon on the button, pumps it up. Well, Jesper's calling this one. And I promise you, Jan Peter Yachman's calling this one. Both his suits are dominated. But it's not a bad gambling hand. Am I going? No, I'm going home to see my baby. I've not played in Monaco for a long time. Way too expensive for me now. 10,000, 50,000, 100,000. Ace, five, six, two diamonds. There's going to be action. It's a flush draw, a pair, and an up and down for Jan Peter. If Thomas Bichon bets, Jan Peter could check raise this flop. If he does, the money is going in. Jesper's should get out of the way. I know he's got top pair and a gut shot. But it's only three outs, really, because the seven of diamonds is no good. Solomon, they probably have. You'll have to YouTube it. I don't really want to mention their name because I'll go on tilt just thinking about it. But there was a crybaby once upon a time. Wow, Jesper Hougaard has called. Don't like this. Maybe he's got plans for the hand. That's what he's thinking. Come on, Jan Peter, stick it in. No, if only he had about 4,000 less, Jan Peter, he definitely would have just bet pot. Pairs the six, kills all the action. I put Jesper as favorite to win this hand now. If Thomas can bet this turn, with his solid reputation, could win the pot. If he checks, Jesper, well, he may just think he's got a showdown, but he must know his ace nine is no good. So for Jesper to win this pot, he has to bet. And he's good enough and able enough to do it. I can't imagine he just called on the flop to hit a three outer. He must have had a plan. Well, he's checked. A straight for Jan Peter. He doesn't need to bet. Give the money to Jan Peter.
Risking.
This could have been a much bigger pot.
Hello, is it me you're looking for?
$10,000. Dollar main event pot limit Omaha. Whoa, champion Jan Peter Yachtamann. He's not afraid to gamble. I've got to tell you, he's a really nice guy. off the table. He's nice on the table, he's friendly, he's action.
Jin, straddle. Eine Runde, alle.
Alle? Ich, alle?
Alle wollen
eine Runde, alle straddle.
So meanwhile, there's a few more of you. If you want to win a King's goodie bag, hoodies, t-shirts, hats, car protectors, loads of different prizes we give away, send us a tweet at Paul Zimbler. How much will the biggest pot of the day be? Closest answer wins a goodie bag.
Baby face, baby race.
There'll be a couple of other prizes later this evening. He's not wearing his bracelet, no. That, in fact, I believe... unfortunately was stolen. But quite a lot of bracelet winners in the building. They've got a nice little trophy cabinet now as you walk in to the King's Casino card room with several of their hashtag players who brought their bracelets in. I don't know what are these Russian Twitch monsters? Not sure what that means. Meanwhile, back in the action.
The guy with the run, Thomas?
Thomas Bichon.
Yeah, isolation.
Ace, double queen, eight, double suited.
It's not my cards.
No. A bit of a mouthful. Well, five high flush draw for Kaiser. Very good player, Swiss. Thomas Bichon, three bet pre, must bet a flop like this, surely. What a turn card, absolutely blessed. Kaiser will probably put him on an overpair then, with no flush draw. So he doesn't need to bet into him because Thomas would call. Now if Thomas checked this flop, he's hit the turn hard. Just a small bet, like a third pot, to build up a pot. Yeah, I like this. Yeah, but he, well, he bet 1600 maybe, I think, but that was half pot. He's not really going to get much out of Kaiser. There's the waiter in the restaurant. If you've never been here, get down. Fantastic hosting skills. Second to none. They do packages if you want to play tournaments where you get your room for next to nothing. Beautiful restaurant here. There's a buffet that's open. Good food that's changed several times a day. It's 24 hours. Free food and drink for everyone.
Bottom race. Right. Pass.
They're just extending the hotel. Because currently, I think there's only about 20 bedrooms in the main King's Casino Hotel. He owns a casino across the road as well. Hotel's there. He's got about six apartment blocks within a 2-minute walk. He owns everything there.
Still in fish? Yeah.
Double shallow.
Sorry, that could be a bit better. I've just turned the mic up. Yeah, make it. That's right. Make it all off the rake. Tips, rake, and hope that these degenerate poker players, not these particular ones, but in general, degenerate poker players, if they win, they try and have a spin on the way out. If they lose, they have a spin on the way out to get out of it. You've got to be a very solid, disciplined player and stay away from the main casino games. Trust me, I learned the hard way. You cannot beat them. And if you've been in and you've won, it's just a short-term loan with very high interest. Is that better? I'd just like to hear what they say at the table. taste of something interesting coming into the headphones. Yeah, raking is a big thing. Every casino in the world, usually you pay around 5%, capped at 10, 15. I think it's capped at 15 here. 5% rake, so out of every pot, they take 5% for the house, capped at 15. Some places it's 10, some places it's 10% capped at 5, other places it's 5% capped at 25. Various casinos. I do recommend, if you are playing cash and you're in a new location about to play, always ask what it is.
Sehr langweilig ohne dich, Jim.
So langweilig.
Das wird nicht. Vielleicht da noch ein Stuhl.
Na, Lüch und da, keine langweilig. Immer Portopo.
Straßen. Okay.
So I've just asked them to turn down the volume of the music coming out by the speakers, by the microphone. Hopefully that should help you. So we're on a half hour delay, so that could take half an hour. Yeah, no, I just went to fix up the sound. Yeah, I'll probably get told off for telling players not to gamble.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm out in the desert already. Leon's a good guy. He loves a gamble. So, a couple of hours in nearly. A couple of pots around the 20k mark. About 2.5 hours left to go. We need these players to start gambling more and get deeper and deeper with reloads. And then we'll get action. What a flop this is for Thomas Bichon. They call this, well, he's got the straight already. If the nine wasn't there, it would be a complete wrap with the ace, queen, ten. Backdoor spades. And those fixed odds terminals, it blows my mind how people gamble on those. You see them, I hear about stories of people in bookies and they're just doing hundreds in a machine. They've got fixed odds. Unbelievable how stupid people are. There you go.
Us playing on the table that promotes the casino. I appreciate the service is good and everything, but still, it's service is good on that table over there as well.
That is true.
Wo ist der Anfang an der Unterstellung?
Bei dir.
Wo mir?
Wirklich? Nein, nein. Da, ich glaube.
Nice answer.
Straddle is on. Jesper's on tilt, he's got to pay. It's the law, unfortunately. What does it matter? You don't complain. In fact, I wrote a little message about it. I find it incredible when I get to the airport. You know, there's a queue to get through security. It's always half an hour, maybe an hour long. And then there's the fast lane, but you have to pay £5. And you're literally, you're first in the queue when you pay £5 and you're through. And it blows my mind how few people spend that £5 and use it. They pay for their aeroplane ticket. They don't moan about the taxes that the aeroplane ticket costs. They get through security and they have to pay £5 for a drink and they don't complain. And yet they'll queue up for half an hour, 45 minutes. They could have children. Just pay the money. Go through the fast lane. You're straight through security. It's no aggravation. Blows my mind. People won't spend £5 on that. Thankfully, otherwise everyone would be in the fast lane, I suppose, and just go through security. But it is bizarre. They say nothing queer as folk. Strange people in the world.
Don't think you're a big
bear. I used to be like that, though. I would spend fortunes on certain things and would not spend... I mean, I would never like to spend £100 on a pair of shoes when I was younger. Clothes or shirts, but I would spend thousands on other things that were just pointless. There you see, Jan Peter, he's only down 10k, not the end of the world. Thomas Bichon, the big winner so far. Not much in it for an hour and a half of pot limit Omaha, to be fair. The swings in this game can be so cruel. That was a solid fold there.
Don't even give us any initiative to play on here. Tomorrow we could just play on and there and they don't have a live stream.
Here he comes, Kaiser. Different gravy, this guy, Kaiser, I think.
100% a principle matter.
Yeah. Very impressed by watching him so far. They tell me he's one of the best in the world, so it makes sense.
If you're playing on the TV.
Yeah, unfortunately, you can't just sit down with 10k.
Yes, different players or something.
You've got to be prepared to pull up. Like in any game, you shouldn't sit in any game with one buy-in. That's just my opinion, though. Pair and a gut shot. Against top pair.
You don't think we can
check,
make this
check.
Over there?
Kaiser, the now is there is good.
But pragmatically, no.
Why not?
And bets it.
And that's the difference. He knows his opponent. He knows his opponent will either bet or check raise. So if he gets check raise, he knows where he is. If he got led into, he knows where he is. When his opponent checks, it gives him the okay to bet. And now it's just a check call. Kaiser will put him on a certain range. He'll know where he is. He's got position.
Because if you can't get these players over here playing that game over there, then that's a sign that
if Jan Peter checks, Kaiser will know he doesn't have the flush. And he can just put like a little 1200 bet in, test the water, take down the money.
Doesn't matter how big is the game.
The decided not to, and Jan Peter Jachtamann caught the miracle card.
That's what I'm saying.
He doesn't need to bet it, though. It doesn't make sense to bet it.
I should be even more encouraged to play here.
But this is Jan Peter we're talking about.
It's a matter of principle.
There are some people that are
on the first game, yeah.
They prefer this game as well, yeah. There are people that are...
So, if those people should play the other people.
It's a matter of principle. They should be paying us a shitload of money to be here. They're not. That's fine. So let's just get the game for free.
Kind of understand where Jesper's coming from, but it is a law.
I mean, for a celebrity like you, Thomas, you should be paid 5,000 euros just to get out of bed. The ratings they get for this program in France, they must be through the roof.
Hagan, wie viele Leute gucken diesen Stream?
I do understand what Jesper's saying. I'm very principle-minded. But in certain scenarios, I mean, I don't know what the fee is. What does it matter? 10 euros, 100 euros? I think the fee's 10 euros.
I have no clue.
I have no clue either. 300.
But they don't rake the game.
It's true. No kidding. There's about 10,000 viewers in Denmark alone. Just because me and Mass are on the table. Good, you got my name, bro.
Well, talking about the viewers, we should do a competition in the chat box and give away a buy into the Omaha event for 6 months. That could be fun. I think everybody would tweet then.
40,000.
On Thursday.
I've lost all the
information. It was in the office. I will find that out for you. At the break. On the starting days, I'll check all that for you. Probably. Do you know if they're half an hour levels? If they're half an hour levels, they're probably playing.
In order to up the readings.
16. But you know, it's a different time zone in China, so maybe there's more people coming from there.
That's true. Gotta think about the international.
Yeah. Let's get Billy on the table for more Chinese viewers.
Billy price. Yeah, Billy.
Hello, Billy.
Billy, put on banco. Später. Jetzt auch dabei.
Weißt du, ja? Kein Frage.
Jedes Mal.
Du musst nicht fragen.
Jedes Mal.
Sofort da.
37 hands in.
Ich nicht, du. Ja. Hast du gewonnen?
Ja, gestern wurde.
Ja, nicht unter Banco. Banco minus.
Unter Banco minus.
Kyle in.
Okay,
looks like a good hand, but it's not such a great hand.
Hello, Billy.
This is a nice hand for Jan Peter. He pumps it up. Well, a three bet. Now, the reason Kaiser's three bet this is he doesn't want to call and play a 5-6 way coup with 10-9, 8-6, 1-2. He wants to get heads up.
Let me the fish shot. One hand.
Now, it's a similar hand. But it's a better hand than what Kai Yin played. Because the kind of working cards, even though they're one suit, and he's got the button. And look at Mads.
Good luck, gentlemen.
King's double suited, pumps it up. Jachtamann should fold. But I'll be honest, can't ever predict what he's going to do. Kaiser, if he fancied a gamble, if that was the 10 of spades in his hand, I think he might gamble, or the 8 of diamonds. Just a bad spot for Jachtamann to gamble. I mean, if that was the Jack of Diamonds instead of the Queen of Clubs, yes, I can understand him wanting to gamble. But Queen, 10-9, one suit.
I hate to fold this nice hand.
You can see the pain is in, but it's an easy fold.
One of my best today.
Kaiser's probably got the best hand to gamble with him against.
Ace, king, double suited.
He is not down.
I think if Mads was on tilt, he might definitely stick it in. Yeah, well, he knows if he catches any part of this flop, he'll probably put him on aces or kings. So even if he just catches a pair, or if it comes 7x, x, he doesn't mind sticking the rest of his chips in. He doesn't need to stick them all in now and go heads up, because you can see a lot of flops and get away Kaiser, but if he flops any part of it, any draw, any pair, he's going to stick it in. And now you might think if it comes deuce, 3-9, he'll put it in, because he's got the 9, and against aces, he's doing okay. It's deuce 3-3. What a great flop for kings. Probably couldn't ask for a better flop without a king in it. It's rainbow. Unlikely anyone's got a 3 in their hand with a 3-bet and a 4-bet. So he can pretty comfortably get it in. He knows no one else has got aces because they would have just put it in pre. He knew exactly what Kaiser was up to. And that was a good hand of poker. Kaiser, I think Kaiser will be the big winner in this game. Very good player. Understands the game, the odds, what players have got. For Oggy.
One day in his shoes, it'd be so nice.
Mads.
Well, not in betting.
With a straight flush draw.
Betting you can't control. That's true. I found out.
Well, the more hearts that come out, the more money Oggy is liable to get from Mads, because less chance he'll have it. I wouldn't go for a pot size bet here. I'd go like 2/3. That 1400 is good.
Can you see regionally where the viewers are from? Like, you have the German and then you have the English version. Can you see where those viewers
are? It is a cruel game, that is for sure. So I think you lose a customer there. You want them in, but you want to give them a bad price, but not too bad a price that they're not going to gamble with you.
Yeah, you can do that,
that's the way I look at it. Other people just want to win the pot there and then. They don't want their opponents calling. If you just play the math, you want them calling, you just don't want them hitting.
But
if they hit, if it pairs the board, you can get away from it.
With blonde hair.
Maybe you can make something like Jesper, single, looking for a girlfriend.
Yep, you should only laugh as well. It's just a game. Bad beats happen.
You need to improve your swing a little bit. Still okay for a beginner.
Or get same clothes like Theo, then you would get likes in the show. That's some sick. Next time we will go all together to play golf and then I will
show my hands again. You have quite a few handicaps, buddy.
Old times, old times.
Couple of little interesting hands. I'm glad you're enjoying it. The minimum buy-in today, 10,000 euros, that's correct.
That's a good idea. But then I'm
training.
Yeah, I don't know yet. Man, Ronny, hör doch mal auf in dem Scheiß. The Wahnsinn, jedes Mal musst du nerven.
This is our international table, though.
Ich wollte nur einen Flop sehen. Ich wollte versuchen, einen Flop zu sehen.
I mean, I'm the second
100, habe ich gedacht.
Most German guy here.
Das ist nicht so
teuer. That has to say something.
True. What's your original background?
Gambia, West Africa.
But you were born in Germany. Can you speak?
Top and bottom for Kaiser. Top and bottom for.
Can
you speak
Yin.
The language? Yin. No flush floor out there. Gut shot as well. I'm just going to go fold call. Top and bottom pair is one of the biggest hands as well as bottom set that will get you into trouble in this game.
Football association, no FIFA, you know, he gets a lot of money.
Yeah, I can imagine.
It's a big job, you know.
Scouting talents.
Good jobs.
I'd say I think Omaha's easier than Holden.
They are.
Better
they
game.
Older than they
gives you, you can have more of an edge.
Yeah, true. Actually, that's...
Holden
like
became so big because it's so easy for anyone to play. You just get two cards, pretty simple. Not too much to think about, even though there is. Omaha, the game of the future.
Still, they beat their African competition, so that's got to account for something at least. It's the smallest country in Africa.
Nothing.
Like
a split pot, unless one player bets. Likely to get called with a check on the. I don't know if it went check on the turn. I was reading the chat. Kaiser. If he puts his opponent on a flush draw, he doesn't even need to bet.
The smaller than.
Yeah, chop it up.
Okay.
Yeah, should say both have 50% chance, but they have 0% chance to win it, because we're chopping it, obviously. It does say at the top of the screen, split 100%. The house always wins. Welcome if you've just joined us. We are playing 50 euro, 100 euro pot limit Omaha here at the King's Casino in Rozhdov. I'm bringing you all the action on the English stream. My name is Paul Zimbler. We'll be here for today. We'll finish here in about two and a bit hours. Then we're going to have a quick break for about an hour. And we are back playing 50, 100, no limit Hold'em this evening. Everybody loves a chop pot except the dealer. So... prizes and goodie bags to be won. Send me a tweet at Paul Zimbler. What will the biggest pot of the day be? My guess, 56,000 euros.
In Mali?
Really? Mookie, I think once you've done the letter, you should type it into the chat box so we can all check it over for you. And I know you're not really going to the gym. That would just be a waste of time. Well, Kaiser has got top pair the blockers. Sorry, top and bottom pair with blockers. No one with a flush draw. Over pair and a gut shot for Jesper. Jesper. Whatever he pronounces, different pronunciations in different places. I say Jesper. And Jan Peter Jachtamann with none of it. So a bet from Kaiser and a call. These guys playing a meta game as well. Zimbler. Look at this, he flops a set. Sorry, turns a set. There is a flush draw. I think I might take a little bet here against Kaiser because I can win it right now if I make a small bet. And if I check and it doesn't pair up the river, you know, I don't really want to have to call a bet. If I'm going to call a bet on the river, if it comes a brick, why don't I just make that bet now and try and win it here and there? It doesn't have to be much. 1,500 is fine. Well, 2,100, just two-thirds pot, gets the job done. Look, Kaiser just folds a straight quite rightly. out of position. He knows if he calls this, he is likely to have to call a bigger bet on the river.
I mean, they won. I made two bets. They had to win with 8.5. They did that. But I had over 270.
You meant to what? Zimble B or Zimble me? Yeah.
They were offering 1.60 quarter for over 230 points, yeah? And in the last quarter, they just, I mean, they didn't do any. It ended like 215. And it was supposed to be like, they had the line at 230.
Okay, how was the result then final?
They won by 20 points.
You talk about the over-under, like,
they won by 20 points. Oh, yeah, yeah. they crossed them, like, with 20 points.
That's what I want.
Yeah. Well,
he talks about his bet.
Yeah.
So the over-under, it was over to go like this, like,
I don't care. I want to explain how bad I'm running betting, you know? I have to wind somewhere. So.
But there was a nice little points. Hand for Oggy.
No bets and stories like that.
They won by 25 points, even though Curry could win.
Zimbleby! This is me.
Mine was out on the rest of the players.
Zimbleby.
Yeah, I was about to ask. He's injured, so
I have a senator.
My account's hidden. I don't know what that means.
Really
I've got no Wi-Fi at the moment. The Wi-Fi's down. Okay, I don't. Can you not message me a tweet?
I actually don't know.
Send me a tweet with it on. I didn't know it was private. When I can get onto the internet, I will get someone to look at it for me and change my account. Maybe you can tweet me in it or something. Send it to me on Facebook then. Facebook me, Paul Zimbler. It's a picture. I don't even know what my picture is. I think it's me holding my baby. Yeah, it's a picture of me holding my baby. So find me on Facebook. And you can send me on Facebook.
Yeah, I'll look it up later. Actually, I tried to look it up. But they didn't offer any bets right now. I assume because they want to wait how the Curry injury plays out.
Yeah, that's
I mean, that's a whole game changer, right?
Six, seven, ten. Oggy, Oggy, Oggy! Why are you raising it so much on a rainbow board? You've lost a customer with top two pair. Yeah, I think that is my Twitter one. That's from the Poker Million. Okay, we're back. Don't know if you guys, can you hear us? We had a power cut. Let me know if you can hear it back. Okay. Yeah, there's not too many Paul Zimblers, but there were quite a few fake accounts set up, so check it's the right one. The Twitter, that was a picture from the Poker Million, I think, and I won the heat there. That was 2009, I think, wow, 7 years ago. Somebody asking if you, yes, only two cards you can use from your hand. And you must use two, it's not a choice. Two from your hand, three from the board. Gut shot. And a pair of sixes to catch a six for Kaiser. Jan Peter Jachtamann. Christmas come early, the jack ball hits the turn. And he's got a player leading out into him. Now, in a multi-way coup, I might be tempted to flat this. Yeah. If you raise it here, you're probably going to lose all your action from any fours that need to connect. And you could find someone behind that would put a squeeze on. Now, he's only got a fade, a king or a four. It's an eight. Unfortunately, that didn't connect with Kai Lin, so he'll check. Jan Peter should bet like 5k. But now even the flush beats Kylin, so he's actually not going to get a dime. We're on a 30-minute delay at the moment. Somebody asking, is the biggest pot for the PLO? Yes, it is, just for the PLO today. We'll have more competitions for the Hold'em. We'll bet 2K trying to get value. I don't mind that. Nope. If it comes four spades on the board and you've just got the bare ace of spades, you do not have a flush. If it comes two aces and two kings on the board and you just have an ace in your hand, you do not have a full house. But if it comes three kings on the board and you have a king in your hand, you do have four of a kind because you'll use your other card as your kicker. So you just have the best five cards, three from the board, two from your hand.
20 Euro, hat gesagt.
All the tweets, if we started at 4-8, must be in within the last until an hour before the end. We're that way, or half an hour before the end. That is correct. Four aces in your hand, you only have a pair. Very rare for that to happen. We were very privileged to see Jan Peter Jachtamann play his four aces when we were at the King's Festival in Prague in December. You can find that video on YouTube, I'm sure. I don't know if I got it, I'll be honest, the Wi-Fi's down here, so I can't get Wi-Fi, or I can't check anything. Oh, it's on. We are on. People going to the gym.
Don't worry about it. Yeah, we could do that. Sure. Got to have we can also do both.
Yeah, that's right. I'm watching it in the room at the back at the same time you're watching it and I'm on a half hour delay.
Well,
so they start
the
half
building,
an hour before I play.
The city is quite big. I think it's like one of the biggest cities. The building could be like a...
Trying to find Twitter. I'm not very good with the...
I need you to do some cardio with your...
That's
what you...
That's a little weird.
Yeah, sure.
Dicks.
I'd be interested to...
Jachtamann
knows.
It
smells a little.
Here we go, messages.
Little smell.
Is that you? Notifications. Watching the high stakes in King's Casino. Biggest pot, Peter. Is that you? Are you Peter? If it is, I've got it. 46,900. Here's Jens, who has his own Twitch TV channel now, twitch.tg/TV. Yeah, blackout. / the real Knossi. Yeah. Pair and a gut shot for Jesper. Complete wrap for Jan Peter Jachtamann with no flush draw. He needs any card from a seven to a king. 7 gives him a straight, an 8 gives him a straight, a 9 gives him a straight, a jack gives him a straight, a king gives him a straight. Now with a 4, a 5 gives him a straight. So 5 to a king that's not a heart. That's a lot of cards. Looks like about 16, 17 cards. He probably thinks he's got less cards to catch because he doesn't want to catch a heart, hence the raise, or hence the bet. You're watching the German with Jens Knossi. Jens is a good character, nice guy. They should be doing some competitions on there as well. Oh, look at that. And you're going to hear, how has it brick, brick, brick? He can only win this pot by betting. Doesn't need to go big. He could look like a value bet and bet like 2.5K. That would be such a great bet. But we can see the whole cards. He's more likely to go bigger. He's bet flop. He's bet turn. He can and must bet river. Come on, Jan Peter. You've got the minerals, we know that. Not afraid to pull the trigger is our man, Jan Peter of Hoka Poka. Here it comes. He's just checking how much is in the hole for and how much more it's going to cost him. Yeah, I tell you, Jesper Hougaard is no fool at this game. He's studying Jan Peter. Such a horrible river card, even though it's given him top two. Yeah, quickly pull those back over the line. It's a great bet from Jan Peter. It's such a tough call. We know it's top two pair, and in Hold'em it's easy to call. I think he may make the call. Of course, if he put his opponent on a wrap, he's got there. Because he put him on a wrap that contained an ace to maybe a nine instead of the wrap that he had. So any ace, any king, any jack, any nine could have given Jan Peter a straight. And for him to bet flop, bet turn, bet river, he could have a set here. So ace, queen, it's losing to a set, it's losing to the straight. Jan Peter's not probably just going to bet a flush draw on the turn. So even though it looks like it's an easy call with top two pair, it's not. It's probably most of the time a fold, but I think against this player he's going to call. Yeah, he's called.
Good call.
Very unlucky, Jan Peter. I mean, it's yeah, come right. The ace to make him call. Would have been really interesting if it didn't come an ace, if he'd have just called with one pair. Probably not. I guess he's thinking he can beat Queen 10. And Jan Peter might beat Queen 10. Might bet Queen 10, I mean.
Did you watch Game of Thrones yesterday?
I watched it.
You watched it? Yeah.
How many episodes? Because I didn't get to see it. I slept and then gym.
Just one.
Sometimes they do, you know, sometimes you can get three.
It was a good hand of poker.
Last year they did four or something.
Yeah,
it's not on purpose. They leaked. They just leaked.
Yeah, how is it? It's a good one?
Nah, yeah. Not really. I didn't. I mean, it was okay, but it wasn't even rated. So.
Well, what a fucking spoiler.
There you go. I mean, kind of like first episodes, right? You have to set up.
Yeah, you need to get into it. Ronny knows all about it.
It's hard.
Ronny the movie maker. Can you see
it? Well, the wheels on this bus might be coming off. The steam is boiling. He's done nothing wrong, Jan Peter. Just a bit unlucky. Keep composure. That's true. It's very unlikely he's got King Jack. He could have had Queen 10 or a set. But he could have had a wrap. King Jack with two blockers. The ace does make it a bit easier for him to call.
if it's a really good rugby episode, you feel the need like to watch it again, right? And
meanwhile, back at the ranch.
Mensen, dat is tot de zeven verlopen.
Ja, ik schaaf tot de zeven hen.
Ja, toch?
Ja.
Ja, en ik ga dat alsje. Is het gaat dat alsje? Betaald.
Waar is dan nou like?
Hoe wie gaat dat alsje?
Twee.
Twee gaat. Nee, beter.
Ein paar Damen.
Ein paar Damen und Porsche des Six.
Und wird welche zwei tauschen? Dame, Dame?
Ja, Dame oder Six.
Straddle compulsory. That's what they're discussing. Get this game livened up.
Thank you.
Four way to the board.
Merci, monsieur.
Check it.
Well, blockers for Bichon. Some blockers for Oggy. He's got top pair on a rainbow board with two jacks in his hand. He's taken a stab with three checks to him. Probably good enough to take it down. There we go. 46 hands in. Matthias, can't remember his last name. He won here the World Series of Poker Circuit event. He's been playing Leon heads up on the outside table.
I see.
He's in the commentary for the German at the moment. If you're a fan of his, you can check them out on live stream. / Poker Room Kings. So somebody asked me about the tournament next week. Starts on Thursday. It's a €100,000 guarantee. It's Dutch Poker Tour. It's a 145 plus €14 buy-in. 40,000 chips, 30-minute blinds re-entry available. So day 1A Thursday, day 1B Friday, day 1C Saturday 12 o'clock, day 1D Saturday at 5 o'clock. the final day on Sunday. And we'll check how many levels they'll play on day one. There's talk of Tony coming. We are trying to get him here. He's very busy. It's more unlikely than likely, let's say. But you never know with Tony. Well, the first one to bet can take this pot.
Super.
I'll bet.
And since...
Not very, when you ask like that.
The 9-ace plays and is good. And I asked them yesterday if they can hear us when we talk, because when we say certain things they put it up on the screen, and it's not, because they're actually putting all the adverts up live. It's just a coincidence. We talk about the Dutch poker tour and there comes the advert. Thomas Bichon folding a hand. Oggy folding ace, jack, nine, deuce, because they're all the same suit. Doesn't want to get involved out of position with a hand like that. Same. Wow, solid discipline fold from Kai Lin. Jan-Peter Jachtamann. Kind of working cards. And Kaiser, aces double suited from the big blind, pumps it up, pot. Bojang all in, I believe. His suits are dominated. Aces. Oh, he's not all in, he's got chips. There you go. Don't know what that's all about then. He must have reloaded. Those green chips you can see in front of Kaiser's stack, they're the 5k chips. The yellows are 1,000. The purples are 500. The whites are 100. The blues are 50.
All your dinners in Monaco. Every single one of them. For the full 2 weeks. I'll leave you 51. I'm going to have a trouble because I'm going to have a paddle.
Paddle tennis?
It's sort of half tennis, half squash. It's inside of a cage. The court is probably most similar to tennis. It's a fun game because you always play it as doubles. So you get sort of the social element in that you're always four on court. And the serve is a lot easier. So you don't like tennis. If you haven't played tennis for a few years, just getting the serve in is quite difficult. Here the serve is on the hand. And it's a fun game because you pick it up really quickly. Like, play two, three times and you can actually get really good value.
Talking about paddle tennis, it's a really tough game actually.
Yeah, that's the kind of racket, like,
and you can play off the walls.
It's got no strings in it.
And if you do play tennis, it's horrible to play paddle, because in tennis you're doing topspin and backspin, but you don't do any of that in paddle.
It's like an aluminium thing with little holes in it. Is it aluminium?
It's definitely a good game for the exercise.
I lost with Theo against...
You played with Theo?
Against Mats Andersen.
And?
One of my worst days.
Well, listen, the only good news about that is that Theo was also on the losing team. Imagine you lose in paddle and you have to have Theo kneeling you afterwards. Yeah. He gives a mean kneel, he really does.
He does.
I played him a ton, but he's been injured for a while now.
You can play it in Denmark?
Yeah, they have a courts in Herlev and Grøndal Center. Grøndal Center has indoor and outdoor courts.
You say Grønland Center, I'm not sure where that is. Copenhagen.
Grøndal Center, you don't know where that is?
No.
Well, a rat and then up, gut shot. Oh, look at this, gut shot straight in.
Yeah.
What a coup. Yeah, it was gut shot with the nut flush draw. He's hit the gut shot. This pot's going to get big.
You're the first sport. You're the first sportsman I know that's spent time in Copenhagen.
Now, if I was Kai Lin, I'd just min raise here.
It's a very nice comment.
Your name is interesting, eh? Fournaise, not very Danish.
French.
So you are a French Danish guy who lives in Vienna, speaks good German.
Yes. He's just very mixed, very mixed identity.
He's insane.
And I'm a sports friend. That's very important.
I worked out with you today. You're an athlete.
Yeah. I don't mind it. No, I don't know.
Okay, ex-athlete. Athlete when you were 16. When you played badminton, if you played at a reasonable level, you must have been somewhat of an athlete.
Oh yeah, yeah. Well, no, obviously, yeah. No, I'm just I wish that computer games were sports.
It's not the same as real tennis. The court looks similar.
They are.
But you can play off the walls. It can bounce once, like in tennis.
It's growing in popularity. This is true.
It's a very tough game.
Yes.
If you're used to tennis, I don't recommend paddle. I found it very tough to play after playing tennis.
I actually think esports, some of those games, is bigger.
But I can't play tennis so much anymore because of my shoulder.
The Global Poker League will not get 20,000 in an arena. Not for a few years at least.
You can also compare it to watching cars and watching people get shot. I know what I want to watch.
You want to watch people getting shot?
No, obviously the cars.
Nice small raise. I don't mind the bet with top set there. Oh, look at this pair, the nine. Absolutely blessed. Not too, so blessed. Of course, Kai did have one blocker. And this should just go like 5,500. Now, if he's just bet called on the turn, he should have had like a two pair or a set hand. So a bet here, I mean, at best, you're splitting the pot if you're Kai Lim facing a bet here from this kind of player. The best scenario you can hope for is you're splitting it. It's very unlikely. You should be behind against this player. Be a very good, solid, disciplined fold. It's 8,400, the bet. That's a pot. If he gets called, we're at the biggest pot of the night so far, I believe. Good, solid, disciplined fold.
5 kilo in Vegas.
Pretty easy to read your opponent who bet called the turn. Raise pre, bet flop, bet called turn. Once it's paired that board.
Jeg tænker, den fulde pakke på Novo.
Ja, okay. I København. Er vi ikke
Novo? Nej, det er ikke i Vegas. Novo. Ikke
Novo,
man.
Novo and Caesars.
There's Noma, yeah, there's two Novos. I'm trying to bet him at dinner.
So if no one reaches it, is it whoever's
just wash. Yeah, it's just, no, if no one makes the, whatever target we set, it's a wash.
Bare aces for Jesper, just calls, you see, good, just flat calls, no point, you've got no suits, you got the bottom end, the wheel draw, a nice little hand from Mads, 10, double, 9, 8, double suited, it's a very good starting hand, unfortunately, didn't flop much, except the gut shot, bare ace of clubs. Thomas Bichon. Thomas has called, and he's called to make a move. Oh no, he's folded. The graphics said he called. Now you're under the gun. You've got three clubs in your hand. People, when they've got three clubs, think it's less likely. But now you're facing a bet with a 10 high flush. If you call the turn, you're likely to have to call the river. A lot of players are just going to give this up. Is one way to tilt your opponent. It's another way to do a few chips. Nice hand, queen, queen, jack, nine, one suit. Excuse me. Bojang not one to fold the button with this kind of hand. The straddler, aces, one suit. Can't imagine when it gets to him, he's going to pump it up. By raising it up here, the only reason to raise and make a squeeze is to maybe get it heads up. And you know in a game like this, it's never going to get heads up. But they're asking how much everyone's playing. Because if he called the 6 and raise, he raises 32, so it's 38 total. Will you get it heads up? Well, he is. Not me personally, I don't like raising out of position a small raise with aces and one suit with no connection to the aces, just because you're going to get callers. So what he's done is he's asked, this is why now it makes sense why he's only made that raise, clever raise. He's asked how much Bojang has left.
I hope I can say that in about 3 minutes.
Because he's raised enough. He's raised in fact, is he under raised? 2 with 4, 4 with 12. Don't know if he's raised enough, because if Bojang moves all in, it could be an under raise. But if it is an exact complete raise, he's very clever to have done that, because if the players now call and they know that Bojang moves in, he can re-raise pot. Screen's gone down, I'm afraid. Okay, it's going to be back shortly. There is the shuttle. Okay, we're back at the table. We can hear the chat. It's been raised. It's been... So, Bojang, I believe, has moved in.
Yes.
And Bichon, if that jack or an 8 were suited, he may even raise it up.
You're right, Ismael, you put me on tilt.
And you see, maybe we get 2 all-ins and we get 2 more people on tilt.
All in for 2,500. It is a complete raise. But all these players knew that Mads was doing it for that reason, that he's likely to re-raise pot. Now that they've all called, he's worried that if he does go pot, they're all still going to call. This could be the biggest pot of the night. Or the day, I should say. And there it is. They knew he was going to do it, yet they still called the 1600. Let's gamble, boys. Well, Jesper's folded. Queen, queen, jack, nine. It's one suit. He knows Mads has got aces. But it makes you wonder why he called the 1600. Maybe he hoped that Bojang would only call just to tilt Mads up. Some players do that. They know why Mads made it 1600 and they would have just flat called out of pure spite. Peter Jachtamann not backing down from the challenge with semi-working cards, double suited.
His
flush draw in hearts is no good. So there's going to be a side pop. Mads and Pete, Jan Peter still with chips. Oh, he's just, has he re-raised?
10-7, yeah. So, jetzt kommt der Moment, wo der Elefant das Wasser lässt.
Okay, we've got a side pot. So this pot now, 22, it's bigger than 17. 17 and 9, 18. About 27k right now. That is the side pot, of course. Well, this flop, it's all going in for Jan Peter. And it's a horrible flop for aces. He's got the better ace of hearts, but this is... he's not going to fold for the remaining 8k. It's a 42,000 euro pot.
Wait. We have to see the cards.
They might run it twice. Oh, I don't know if they can run it twice. They might be allowed to run the side pot twice.
I like my hand, though.
I like Jan Peter's hand. Now, Bojang has got the bigger flush draw. Top pair and a gut shot. Jack, 9-7, the queen needed.
For the fun of it.
Queen to give like the straight.
Eight of spades.
Four of diamonds. Five now for Jan Peter. The seven of diamonds makes the straight for the aces. Nuts. We need to know how much this pot was.
It was 26, 8, 8, 16,
16, 22, I think 42,000 euros. So we're getting up there now. What a pot. For Mads. Yeah, he hit a straight. Runner straight. Game on. The two players you want to be a little tilty to get the action going are the ones reloading. I think Jan Peter loaded for 20k. So we're back tonight for the 50-100 No Limit Hold'em. Tomorrow, same time, 4 o'clock, 50-100 PLO for 4 hours, an hour's break, and then back to the Hold'em. Got about an hour and a half left today. Not too late to win yourself a little goodie bag. Send us a tweet at Paul Zimbler, Zimbler. What will the biggest pot of the night be? Don't guess less than 42,000 euros, because we've just had a pot that size. Aces and threes with one suit in the big blind, flat calls. I don't mind that. I play it the same way. Unlikely to be many aces left in the deck, so it's not a great spot. $78k, you've got to send a tweet, I'm afraid, because if you write it in the chat box, I won't be able to confirm it after, because we don't see the chat back. And now Mads is going to start putting pressure on, quite rightly so. He's got the chips. Oh, I think he just reloaded 10,000, young Peter. Twitter, so last year, I don't know. What do you use? I only have Facebook and Twitter, I'm afraid. So 1990s. Oh, look at this, he's raised it up, Kaiser. Smells the weakness. What hand does he think Mads has got to have let out? He knows what Mads is up to. This Kaiser, different gravy. Nope, just the PLO. We'll have separate competition this evening for the Hold'em. And I got a feeling the biggest pot will be in the Omaha anyway, with the lineup that we've got for the Hold'em. Not only that.
15? 15?
He's folded. Now Mads has got, they say in the trade, sweet FA. Nothing wrong having your fingers caught in the cookie jar. Nothing wrong with taking a stab and trying to pick up the money, but Kaiser, his radar is working full capacity today. He knows what's going on, and that's what's important about live poker. Paying attention to situations, what's going on around you, who's in what frame of mind. He knows Mads is the big winner, and Mads is going to be using those chips. Omaha, it's a lot easier to be using your chips to make chips, a bit like in a tournament, than it is in a Hold'em cash game. And he took full advantage. He's losing just under 11,000 at the moment, Ronnie, but I'm pretty sure he's going to be a winner at the end of this session unless he's unlucky.
That's the good thing about the street, right? He checks. Yeah. But not this time.
Signing autographs for 10,000 euros a pop? No. Every time they call chips up to the table, of course, they're not going to the cash desk to pay for their chips. So what they do is they put money on deposit, and then they call for that money at the table, 10,000 chips, but they have to sign to release the money because it's their own money that's being held at the cash desk. So rather than having to go to the cash desk and sign for it and receive the chips themselves, the cash desk release it to the floor people, then they get a signed document. The player signs it, goes back to the cash desk, so it's all accounted for. Thanks, Fax. I am here. And I'm a very happy daddy. Side pots, yeah, like if a player's all in and there's more action, of course there has to be a side pot. Because the all-in player can't win the rest of the money the other guys have got. I'll be honest, I didn't do too much to make the baby. I did the easy part. My missus is the one that's doing all the hard work. Bless her. She's a good girl. Hougaard with the flush. He knows he's good now. He might even try and stick a small value bet in of 1,000 to get paid from a straight or two pair or something like that. I wouldn't be surprised to see a value bet there. I would value bet my 5-high flush. Right, he's just gone for 400 just to hope to get something. Yeah, if, like, well, treble up. Like, if you're all in for 500 and a player behind makes it 5,000 and the other player calls, the other two players have their 500 that they put in into the main pot, and then the rest goes on the side. Good luck to that. Getting back to the online grind. 6 months off, huh? Where have you been? Anywhere nice? Yeah, I think it's a lot harder to change to Hold'em after playing Omaha. And you get bored when you play Hold'em. At least in Omaha, if you're bored, you can just get involved. There's so many more hands. And pilot training. I might need you for my new business. I need pilots. I need captains. I need army men or ex-army men. Best business idea I've ever come up with. I just need about 20 million to start it. Any backers?
Performance is out of the same.
I flew a plane about, I think it was about a year and a half ago. My missus bought me flying lessons. So much fun. Can't wait till I've got spare time. I'd love to learn to fly properly, take my pilot's license, get my boat license. 20 million? I don't need that much, thanks. 10% on a tenner, you're in. I think it was the best decision of your life. I didn't know you could ban yourself for a certain amount of time. A Welsh terror, spot on. Tied up I was. Ace, queen, jack, 10-1 suit. 6553 for Hougaard. Not a bad gambling hand. Well, not a bad PLO hand, I should say. You're gambling with all hands. On the button as well. He's disciplined. He knows Jan Peter's calling, so he knows he's going to get the right price on his hand. So I'm really surprised. 6553, I believe it was. This could get him on tilt if he hits the flop. Six, double, five, three, flop, bottom set. And up and down. Could have got him into trouble. I can't remember if he had clubs. It's not the best flop to try and c-bet with. That might not stop Kaiser, because he knows Jan Peter is a bit tilty, and if he had a hand, he'd probably just lead out. Now, depending on the turn card texture, he may bet. If it's checked to him now, it's likely... he's likely to have a stab. I'm pretty sure he's betting this. Doesn't make sense to check it. You have no hand. Okay, gut shot nine, but... not a tournament, this is a cash game, and we started at 4 o'clock on the stream. We'll be done by 8 o'clock. We'll have an hour's dinner break and we'll be back for the No Limit Hold'em from 9 till 2.
Bitte, gestern warst du Abo-Teser. Wie heißt der dieser? Wie heißt der dieser Linkflash?
Ribeye, oder?
Ribeye. We are going to have Tobias Rein, Tobias Reinkenmeier, Tobias Reinkenmeier, Nivbury Quirinzek, Igor Kurganov, Daniel Pidden, we saw him yesterday, SR, not sure who SR is. Martin Cabril and Roman Herald. So it is a slight change. Doesn't look like Oggy is going to be playing later. or Besim. We needed Besim hot. SR is Sharam. He was on earlier. So they're just the two changes to the fixtures for this afternoon's game. Ace, Jack 10 double suited, I believe, is the best hand. Ace, King, King, kind of counter, the King's counteracting because you've got the aces in your hand. The reason it's ace, Jack 10 is because you can make straights. So ace of hearts, 10 of hearts, ace of clubs, Jack of clubs. Ace is double suited with all the straight options. Mads. Nice hand. 5-6-8-8. Nice. Yeah, Queen Jack 10-9 double suited. Also a very good starting hand. Any four working cards that are double suited are good, and this is a good action flop. Kaiser with the straight and the blockers. Top set. For Jan Peter. This could be Kaiser and Jan Peter playing a big pot. Jan Peter's getting it in, don't worry about that. He's only got 6k. In it goes. Unless you plan on just calling, and if it comes a heart folding. No, it's going in, it's being called. Snap call, they might decide to run it, you don't know. Near enough a flip, as you can see on the screen. Top set. If it comes an eight.
Top set against Strasse.
An eight, Jachtamann wins. Wow, look at this, he's come the eight. That's so tilting for Kaiser. An eight was needed. Or a pair up for Jachtamann. And that gets him 15k. He's in for 40. It could have all been going south if he lost that pot. Yeah, Peter Jachtamann, grateful to win a flip there. Once you're in for 40k in a game that's not that much action, it's very tough to get out of it. You end up forcing the action and likely to do 100k or get out of it. Mads back in the action. Quite rightly so. Jachtamann rightly folding. Kaiser's on the button. With he believes it's edge in the game and position. He'll call with any four most of the time.
Every end, Ronny. Every end.
And Oggy. Yeah. Don't know about this one. A lot of players like to call when they've got pairs in their hand, but 9-7-7-3. Very few flops are going to help you, and the ones that do help you aren't really going to get you paid. And they call this a wrap for Mads. He needs any king, any jack, any 10, any 8. So you can see he's a massive favourite. He's got backdoor clubs as well. But he'll bet and win it now.
I like your shirt. What is it?
Thank you.
Jump in, send a tweet, let me know what you think the biggest pop of the night will be. Win yourself a King's goodie bag. A fucking new beach bag with hoodies, t-shirts, hats, car protectors, all sorts of stuff. Cards.
From like a little small boutique.
And we got both colors, you know. So in the gym today, we agreed that he will take the blue one and I take the black one.
You have both a good understanding about this.
We do.
I like your sense of fashion.
Yeah.
Well. Danish sportsman, poker player.
As
Ronny. Look at that. The player that went to the gym this morning has got all the money in front of him. He prepared well. He knows he's got to sit here for 5 hours. Get into that gym, get yourself feeling good. Get those endorphins flowing.
To be vintage, not to be fashion.
A lot of these players just play all night, wake up, grab something to eat, jump straight into the game.
Art.
Preparing to win is vital.
It's an invitation.
It's a good invitation.
Puppy!
Actually, I'm not so sure about that.
I didn't see that. That's
35.
I think it's too much. So, 24.
He played so patient in the last 2 hours.
Kai Lin, now free betting. So he calls, he straddle, waits for someone to raise behind, and then free bets to really build the pot. So don't mind with the aces. Aces one suit. I prefer to limp raise than I do just to raise.
Okay.
He raised there just to build a pot. Not the greatest hand, but
seven. Yeah.
Now, it's not such a bad flop for Kai Lin because he's got the bare ace of hearts in his hand, but he's got to assume there's players top card that have either flop wraps or two pair or sets. He's all in for his last 3,200. He's getting called by Mads. Thomas must surely fold this. If he thinks or he knows what Kai Lin has, Thomas could just raise here to get rid of Mads, hoping Mads has missed everything, to go heads up against the aces when you flop one pair. The problem is if you flat call here and get raised, you're in trouble. So if you're going to make the move, make it. And if you walk into a hand, you walk into a hand. It's just easier to throw it in the bin. ITB in the bin. Yeah, he's made the move, and that it looks stupid, but he's made this move because what he wants is he hopes Mads has got nothing, and if he's got one pair with three live cards against aces, as long as Kai doesn't have the flush draw, he's basically flipping. He's very unlucky that he's walked into Mads that's got a hand, but Mads got the kind of bottom end basically just up and down with a pair. So it's a very tough spot for Mads. If that seven was a king, the money's going in. It looks like it's a fish move, but it's not. For the money that's in the pot, what he's actually doing for 3,200, he's going heads up against Kai Lin, who he's put on aces. So it's actually a very technical, good move. It's ballsy. And look what's happened. You'll see the odds on the screen now when he folds. Well, he's 30%, but it cost him 3,000 to win all that, to win the basically, to win 17,000 as a 30% shot. And Mads is not happy, but Thomas, I believe, it's not the worst move. It's ballsy, but if you don't walk into a hand behind you, you do have one ace blocker, which is no good. Jack on the turn, no help. Six on the river is two pair for Thomas Bichon, and he will take that pot.
Jackson
falls
for screens.
That's his. That's gerne normal. Kauf eine Sechs, diese Ball.
Keine Nummer, Jacking Issue. Men det var, når han begynder at...
Keine Nummer.
Jeg ved ikke, han raised free, og han har været meget stramt. Han har en højere range. Så jeg gik ud fra, at han havde bloggers til min...
I wouldn't do it with an ace in my hand. Because if my opponent's got aces, that ace is dead. But if you flop a pair, And you got three working cards, yeah, live cards with it.
One of every.
What do you have, Mads?
Jack 10, 9, 8, 7.
I don't know. If you call and your opponent behind has a hand and moves in, yeah, you can't call. So
just a straight
throw. Yeah, Thomas Bichon wins with two pair. He was a short stack, so he 3-bet pre to leave him with a few chips.
You raised three flips, so I was thinking you had some life outs, I imagine you took some buggers.
If we did an interview with Thomas and we asked him why he did that, it's exactly, I'm sure, what he'd say. For 3,200, I could win that pot by myself. I'd have to risk the extra 8,000 myself. But he's here to gamble. They shouldn't be allowed to speak.
950.
That's your person's job, but there's so many different. They're speaking German as well, but German is allowed at the table. There are three languages allowed to be spoken at the table in general when we play here at the casino. That's Czech, Dutch, and English. Oh, wow. Look at this. It's a 4-bet.
950.
No. What's happened here? Raise, re-raise, and I think Jachtamann is potting it up. Draw one suited aces. Kaiser. Might just want to see all four cards. I mean, this could be a big pot too. Should be a big pot. Look at that. That is disarming. Probably could think he's got three spades in his hand and he's either going to get no action from his spades or the aces out there. You must know Jan Peter's got aces or kings. He's just got out the way. Thomas Bichon, 10, 9, 8, 6. There's four working cards. Why not? Let's get these pots big. These guys want to gamble. He's flopped top pair. And he knows he's against Jan Peters. If he assumes he's against aces or kings again, this time he's got four live cards. So you can see he's 43% as opposed to being a 30% chance last time. So that was the odds. Flopping one pair against aces with live cards, you can see it. The money's going to go in. If he did it last hand, he's going to do it this hand. Because it's kind of a free roll to do it this hand.
Before I shot my hand.
My hand is obvious, so.
So.
I always go once.
Yeah, but it's 10k to win 30k, so it's you're 43% getting over 2-1. It's a mathematical situation that you do X amount of times, it should be profitable. Clubs have improved him. Pairs the three. Jan Peter Jachtamann wins this pot. 44,650. Maybe the pot's not that big. Yeah, with a 3-bet pre, 10, 20, I think it was like 30-odd K. There you go, you asked for it, there it is. Jesper Hougaard is up 10K. Kailin down 10, Jan Peter only down 8K now, he's in for 40. Ronny Kaiser down 15, he's reloaded, he's got 35 in front of him. Ismael Bojang down 10, Thomas, he's up 3 now, just lost the big pot. Ognjen up 10,000 and Mads 24K in profit. Very difficult if you're a Hold'em player watching Omaha to kind of understand the dynamics. It's a completely different game. Definitely a gambling game, and if you're a gambler in a gambling game, you're taking your chances and playing the odds. 600. Let's put it this way. If you were playing a 50p £1 game and it cost you £30, would you call? Would you bet call? Because the £30 is irrelevant, but you're getting the right odds. You would. These guys, they're playing within their bankrolls. It sounds like a lot of money, 10,000, but when you're playing within your correct bankroll and you're just playing a mathematical equation, you gamble. Hold'em will start at about 9 o'clock. They go live at 8:30. We'll be back in the box by 9.
Check.
Check.
Well, he had an up and down. He's turned a set. He's way out in front. Ace on the river for action. Nope. Kailin.
Us.
He's just going to take the money.
Unkelini.
Gel. The lineup for the Omaha. Sorry, for the Hold'em. We've got Tobias Reichemeyer, seat one. Livbury in seat two. Quirin Zek in seat three. Igor Kurganov, seat four. Daniel Pidham, seat five. SR in seat six. Martin Cabril, seat seven. And Roman in seat eight. It's going to be 50, 100, so 10,000 min sit down. Kings, queens against ace, king, 10-9. Action.
What?
Yeah.
Alles weg.
What is
it? Yeah.
No problem, pal. No problem at all. Don't forget, win your goodie bags. Easy, all you've got to do is pick a number. Would have been a good flop for Jesper that folded. Well, an okay flop. Anyway, this pot is Mads going to take a stab. He knows his opponent doesn't have an ace or a jack because he would have bet. Oh, he's check called.
Tricky.
A nine or a queen. It's an eight. A date with an eight. He doesn't know it, but he's winning. Mads. I mean, he's okay to bet here, he's okay to check here. He's afraid he's going to get called. Do you want to waste it? Or are you going to go, I'm not giving up this pot. I'm going to go half pot. And just try and nick 5k. Against a player that didn't really want to get too involved in this hand after three betting pre. Oh, he's been straddling all day, Jan Peter. Maybe he just forgot last hand. So the tweet is at Paul Zimbler. Just tell us what the biggest pot of the day will be here in the Omaha session. You win yourself a goodie bag. We'll have a few more competitions later this evening. I was going to say there was going to be a competition for the first player to name that's all in and reloads. And unfortunately, that happened in the first hand, so we didn't even get time to do that. Oh. We love Omaha action. The sickness. The degeneracy.
Nein!
Das darf doch erleben. Ich würde
sagen, ob ich den Walk gebe, aber. Ich gebe gleich mein Hemd auf.
Excuse me. A new dealer. 64 hands in. In 3 hours. Not bad. Just over 20 hands an hour at Omaha. 1 hour to go. Competition closes in about 20 minutes. I believe a dealer brings a new deck every time she... No, they don't in this game. Maybe they do. Swap every half an hour, they come with a deck. Players like new dealers to come with a deck, change things up. Look at that! Kaiser flops quads. He needs to find a king. That ace has killed the action. Unfortunately, he thinks it'll be a good card for him. Still checks it. Ognjen. 800 is 800 in English. Pretty simple to understand that one. I think what they're trying to do, Jan Peter, is get everybody to straddle. Kaiser calls. He'll obviously now check the turn, which has probably stopped Ognjen betting because he may put his opponent on a flush draw. Can he find a check on this river? He knows his opponent is unlikely to call him if he bets. So horrible. It's so rare to flop quads when your opponent has got nothing. His opponent bet this flop. You've got the deuce in your hand, so what can he have? It's come the flush and he's checked behind. He hasn't bet the turn. A player would have bet the turn if they had the flush. Kaiser thinks he might have got called by an ace. Oh, when the... Yes, there you go. So they don't bring... Of course, yeah. It's a shuffling machine. Dealers don't bring cards. There's two decks. A red deck and a blue deck, I assume. It's a shuffling machine. So she collects the cards, put them in the machine. When they come out the machine, they do the cut.
It's actually a protein bar, but... Yeah, I just said in Danish that
it's an excuse for eating chocolate.
He's the exact right person to make a weight loss that way. No discipline whatsoever.
Weight loss bet. I should do that. Maybe I can motivate myself. Yeah, really.
I don't really need you though.
I mean, I'm not a girl, you don't have to be charming to me.
No, but there comes a certain point when you have, like, girlfriend or wife, kids and stuff, and it doesn't really matter that much. But as long as you're single...
I'm not single, what are you talking about?
You're not single, that's why it doesn't really matter.
My girlfriend is pregnant, that's why I'm
exactly.
Still pregnant.
Yeah, exactly, it's a show of sympathy for you.
Yeah. She's wondering that I
who's
did
the
gain more. Did gain more weight.
gut shot in the second, that flush draw for Bojang against Kaiser's set. Well, he's bet the flop and only got called. Surprised he doesn't bet the turn.
It's a matter of like, goodness.
I feel like it's a complete brick. Unless these guys play together a lot. And he knows that Bojang's likely to lead out. If he smells weakness.
I don't feel very uncomfortable. No, not really. I'm not thinking like, oh, it's not like I think I want to be like, useless.
Now you've given a free card for all the draws.
At the end of the day, it's not about.
That ace has changed nothing really for the set of nines. Because King Jack would have had the flop straight anyway. So if you check behind, I might stick a value bet in here and hope he had a hand like Ace King or Ace Jack, and now he's made two pair and would call me. But I would have bet the turn with my set. He's only got one pair ace. All he can beat is a bare bluff. And if his opponent had the ace of spades, likely to have made two pair or have. I mean, what you're hoping for, a flip pot at best. So he's folding. If I check turn there, I would have checked river. Because if I check turn, it makes it look like I'm on a draw, my opponent's on a draw, I would check the river. But I would bet turn and bet river. But if you do check turn.
That's right. So this is just a snack.
Yeah, me neither. I bet my set on the turn there. Your opponent cannot pay for draws on the river because there's no more cards to come. And if you build a pot by betting the turn and they just call, you can put them on the draw hand. Then you can check the river. Then they can't help themselves to bluff because it's the only way they can win. But who am I to educate? Well, wholesaling service, some good advice. If you don't expect, you won't be disappointed. It's free advice I got from my mum years ago.
Always curry,
yeah.
Dry aces, they call these. That means they're not connected to any suit. Yeah, and Peter Jachtamann is not folding, surely. Yep.
He's
wow,
really?
That's a good try. Very good try.
Hamburg just changed the beer firm who delivered it. Mm-hmm. They now have Königpilsner. They had for, I think, 30 years Holsten. Mm-hmm. The German Holsten. Mm-hmm. I think it's even from Carlsberg. It's Holsten.
Nicht mehr yet.
No.
Holsten was bought from Carlsberg breweries,
yes.
10 years ago.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yeah. Holsten is one of the biggest breweries.
Yeah. And now they lost Thoas, so now it's going to go downhill.
Oh, well, I think they got a good offer from the other.
I want to win a hand.
No, but it's funny because now outside of Sweden, Holsten tries to make some advertisement and make some out where they can. They put some. So some fans go there before this day and think they're what they're used to, you know?
I just keep folding for 4 hours. It's so boring.
Ice
for
the water, yeah?
Exactly.
I've got your tweet, Michael, but I didn't understand what the 250-416 meant. We got the guessing, quite a few messages and notifications. Not too late. Send in the tweet. The button is neither SB or BB. The button is DB. SB is small blind, BB is big blind, and it could just be D that comes up on the screen. It's either D or DB, but it should just be D for dealer.
I want
to
see that
hand.
I actually never bluff.
Just a semi-bluff.
Wie sich dann ein bisschen aufbaut.
How does that logo even stay on there? It looks like it's just about to peel off. 48 Jahre It was just stuck in the middle.
Noch ein bisschen frozen hier, it's okay.
In Japan.
The Dutch poker tour next week.
What does it mean?
This week, I should say. Day 1A Thursday, day 1B Friday, 2 day ones on Saturday. €145 plus €14 tax buy-in. €100,000 the guarantee. 30-minute levels, 40,000 chips. Such great events they run here at King's. On top of that, you can get packages where if you buy into the main event, you get massive discounts. I mean, the rooms are next to nothing.
Your word, not mine.
What a flop this is. Oh no, I thought he had the ace of diamonds for Bichon. Well, he's got a wrap. Ace, any deuce, any five, any six. Of course, he'd want the ace. That would give him the nuts with deuce five and top set. Deuce five is the up and down for Kaiser. He's calling the thousand.
Before there was, they was sleeping, you know.
And you woke them up. So you can incorporate that brand into sports betting as well?
No, thank you. If you guys didn't tune in, we wouldn't be here. It works. Like hey, just folded the up and down. Kaiser. Maybe he's given too much respect to Thomas.
With sports betting and with different casinos. We even make an advertisement for, let's say, blackjack tournaments or whatever. If a casino says we want to market, we want to advertise, we do that.
We have if they want to pay... You'll take their money.
We have deals with casinos in Austria or we have some Berlin and this and that. And they say, and I tell them, it's not like some years before people said, oh, what has this to do with poker? We have to live on it. People get in, you know, they can choose. What they, every day, like 15 years, they can choose what they want to see. Mm-hmm. It's okay.
But
it's
they can
free,
set up,
it's a free for the view.
They can set up filters so that they can do like what type of news they get. So if they don't want sports betting,
it's a very interesting question you asked there. What do the numbers mean? That is, it's 3.8 to 1. So while they come up with the percentages, it gives you the decimal point odds. So we'll have a look now. 68%. 16%. Excuse me, split options up the top. 16%. So 68%.
Yeah.
So it's 2 points, 5 to 1.
Yeah.
5 to 1.
Leave a comment.
But I'm still waiting for that music video that you promised me.
Pretty sure
that's
what they mean.
Something now I will maybe plan. This was not in the main, let's say. There's some other things now.
What? You just need to.
I would like it, and I still think it's a good.
I think there's a few, but I won't mention names.
Has to have, in order for it to go viral.
Well, if you want to play him, get to Vienna. That's where he's a regular.
Yeah. If it's, you have like Thomas Bichon guest
star. I'm around,
like
straddle.
That really
only me, I will do.
So everybody, compulsory straddles are coming on.
You can have a pie.
I need a pie. Yeah. Good, then mach ich trotzdem.
Oder ein Amulett von gestern.
Ja.
Ein Amulett von gestern. Jetzt nicht mehr, ne?
Ein Amulett?
Ja, gestern ein Amulett, sage ich, nein, das ist kein Glück.
Von der Lack.
I think there's a couple of good spots at the table.
These
guys have to play anyway all the time, high stakes. When you play high stakes, a lot of the time you're at a table with only a couple of good spots. I think there's several spots in this game, and it's quite. I think this is a very good game.
Indians. One say they have an amulet, some other have an omelet.
I think you needed a Leon in this game as well. That would make it spicy.
Yeah.
Then my guess would have been 80,000 at the biggest pop. So 44,600 so far, the biggest guess.
Jack, deuce, deuce. Almost. See, Jack, deuce, deuce.
He asked for Jack, deuce, deuce. Little does he know, Kaiser was praying for the Jack, deuce, deuce flop. But he'll take a Jack, seven, deuce board. And he now knows Jachtamann has got deuces. Goodbye, Ian. Peter, we know he can't fold sets. We've seen him even when he tanks for 10 minutes and nosebleeds behind. He's stuck in, I think, we were at Prague in December. There was a huge pot against the player that just made a massive fold against him, and the next hand took his whole stack set over set. Jan took 10 minutes, knew he was behind. I think even the guy had quads. Jan Peter just had a bad full house and called him Kaiser. It's a rainbow board. If he raises here, his hand is face up. But he believes it's against Jan Peter, and if Jan has got a set of sevens or deuces, he's going to stick him in. But think about this. It's not a draw-heavy board, Jan Peter. Unless he's got 8, 9, 10 in his hand. Two backdoor flush draws. Yeah, and Peter already knows he's in trouble, which means if he continues in this hand, he's drawing dead. It says he's got an 8% chance. That's because they think there's another a deuce left in the deck, because it doesn't account for the whole cards the players have got. We can see the deuce is in Kaiser's hand. He just picked up clubs. It's going to be a full-size pot bet against this player. Problem is, if he had a wrap, he would have just got there. But Jan has picked up the flush draw. And if he does bet pot, it's more likely that he doesn't want a caller. Against Jan Peter myself, I'm betting like 8.5k. Seven of clubs. Wow, he's checked again on the turn. Four on the river. Now, Jan, maybe he's just checked so he knows he gets paid on the river. Now, Jan Peter should check call, because if you bet and get raised, you're in trouble. If you bet and get called, what are you getting called by here? What do you think? Jack 10. That's right, the only hand that would call your bet. All bluffs would raise, all bigger hands are going to raise. So something a bit earlier, like Bojang had when he had the full house, and he bet flop, bet turn, bet river, when it's just a bad river bet, because he got raised and had to fold. I'd really be impressed to see Jan check this. I think he's going to check call a very big bet. I think it speaks for itself. The text under there says what they've got. Oh yeah, I don't know why it says kicker jack. Yeah, three of a kind with jack 10. That's his five whole cards. You need a five card poker hand, so he's got three of a kind twos, 10 jack. That's his made hand. But why do you want pot control against Jan Peter? You got top set. Jan Peter didn't lead out. He's gonna check call a lot. With all his draws, he's calling. I don't like this bet at all. Oh, sorry, no, he checked. I thought Jan Peter was about to bet. And he's bet full pot. And Jan Peter's not going to fold. He's not going to fold. And that's why he's checked the turn. Because when a brick comes, he knows he's getting full pot. He's afraid that Jan Peter may not bet, call a bet on the turn. And if he does have deuces and it pairs up, he probably can get more than the pot size bet, because Jan Peter might bet call the river. So that would be Kaiser's thought process. He got raised on the flop, checked back to on the turn, and bets pot on the river. So it's either a set that didn't like the turn card, or it was a wrap that made the straight on the turn and gave you a free card to get you on the river. If you're Jan Peter, Kaiser's not really stepped out of line too much today. I told you, this bottom set gets you into trouble in this game. Jan Peter finds a fold, I'll be very, very impressed. Well done, Jan Peter. Kaiser will be feeling sick right now, especially in half an hour. well, I guess he'll be seeing it now, that his opponent had a set. Go. He can pat himself on the back. 6 months ago, a year ago, Jan Peter Jachtamann would have lost £26,000 in that, €26,000 in that pot. I know, I'm in shock myself right now. The old Jan Peter, especially when he's in the hole. I think it's very player dependent as well. There's a lot of players he might call there.
Ian.
Pass.
Okay. No, he's no fish. He likes to gamble, and he's happy to gamble and take bad odds. He doesn't mind that part. But he wants to make sense of the situation. I would love to ask Ronny Kaiser his thought process in that hand. As to why he didn't bet the turn against the player that's likely to pay him with all draws and two pairs and sets, let alone a set and a flush draw. Well, he's still down a fortune. He is still, I mean, he doesn't have more than like 20 odd K in front of him, so he's still down 20K, and that was a chance to get out of it. If he calls and wins that pot, he's in profit, so that would be more reason for him that he'd want to call. Jachtamann with us, he's got 26k in front of him. Still, he would have been in front. Kaiser, set over set this time, and watch how Jan Peter will get him. Two hearts. There is a straight there. 5-7 or 5-deuce completes the straight. Now, an 8 is a bit of a scary card. He could bet a little bit for value, not go too crazy. This could probably just go check, check. Interesting to see if he wants to bet. He's got two blocker sevens. Is he going to bet a set for value? I don't think he will, the way he played the last hand. Correct. That is correct. That's why I may not have raised the flop myself. I may have called flop, raised turn. Then he calls, then we can get busy on the river. Anyway, it's all different. Different horses for different courses. And now Jachtamann, the same predicament. A little bit of a different story though. Bit unlucky if he's walked into it, but he's gonna pay this one and he's gonna see the good news. Yeah. Kaiser losing another pot. Yeah, you see, check flop, bet turn, different, completely different scenario to the last hand. And the next hand will be different. 71 hands in. Minutes to go on the Omaha. Seven, 7-6-5. Nice little hand. Yeah, and Peter Jachtamann finds boots. One suit, I can see. Up and down for Oggy. So an over pair, bottom pair, backdoor hearts. instant service pairs the king will make Jachtamann a big favourite. The reason it says 100% to Oggy is because we can't see the card belonging to Jan Peter to complete the information to give the right odds. Jan Peter, I don't know what his other card is. Oggy has not played too many hands. And he'll give him that respect, even for 1,100. Good bet. Half pot as a semi-bluff. Double suited. Bojang in the big blind. Suited ace. Thomas coming along. Surprising. That's a nice flop. Trying to rep a few things. See what mood Mads is in. Yeah. He knows Thomas is solid. He knows Bojang is in a bit of a hole. Jack high flush draw and one pair. I mean, he's just never going to flop too good a hand with these kind of... Why four working cards are so important. So if you call him pre-flop, because it's double suited, and you flop a draw. Five on the turn, now gives Bojang the up and down. Complete wrap. And Mads has improved his hand, he should now bet again. Let his opponent pay the price. Don't go crazy, bet half his stack. I might bet a bit less, like 2.5, so I can bet 3 on the river. He's gone for the other way round. A few hundred euros here or there won't make a difference. Problem is, you're up and down, and if your opponent's got 8-9 in their hand, you don't want to hit the 8, because you're probably going to be in trouble. So now you've only got the 4 to complete the straight. Probably behind with one pair, so you just... The moral of the story is don't get involved with these kind of hands out of position that often against aggressive players. Against passive players, it's a bit different. You're often going to get to see cheaper cards, get free cards. Aggro players don't give free cards. He has called. I think it's more of a tilt call. He doesn't know he's a massive favourite. A 3 on the river. He's hating life. Oh no, sorry, the 3 is the card he wanted. I thought you wanted a 4. He's only gone and made the straight. And he's checked. I love it. If opponent did have a big draw, he has to bet to win the pot. Perfect play on the river from Bojang. He's hit the absolute miracle card to get him out of it. He thought he was a complete dog in the hand. He didn't know if his flush draw was good. If it was, he had about 11 outs, 22% odd. So he's calling 3 into 8. As it happens, he was in front. Last half an hour of play. 5 minutes left to get your guesses in for the biggest pot of the night. Send a tweet at Paul Zimbler, notification message, whatever it is. Goodie bag to be won. Then we're going to take an hour's break and we are going to be back for some no-limit hold'em action this evening. 50, 100 the blinds. Liv Marie will be in the building. She's coming with Igor. Action hands. Mads with a genuine hand. Oh, genuine. Gravy. No problem, 09. Good luck with that. We will see you later on. Change of dealers for the last session. So they're just talking about this tournament this evening. Fantastic value if you're around. Likely to be an overlay. 63 plus €7 buy-in, so €70 total. Two re-entries allowed, 20,000 chips, 20-minute levels, €10,000 guaranteed. 8s for Jachtamann this time. He's got a gut shot. Two pair for Kaiser.
What kind of work do you think Ronny would do for €70 if he had to run like two of us? Yeah.
Something is entertainment though. Something that it seems. Can we pay that job?
You would do that for free. I don't want it to end.
The old rival,
Jan Peter.
The problem on the streaming, it's always the same two guys.
Bet called a raise. Going to bet call a raise. It's Bojang. What are you going to do on the turn? Just, what, check call? No, you're going to lead out and win this pot. Yeah. The stream's on today and tomorrow. We had a session last night as well. And win the Dutch tournament also. What does that mean? The WPT in and with the Dutch tournament also. I don't know what the Dutch tournament, the German, the Dusche stream. I don't know if they probably stream the final table of the Dutch Poker Open. On the live stream, they do that. So live stream / Poker Room Kings. And in there, you've got Jens Canossi giving you the action in German. I don't like this from Jan Peter at all. Myself. If you're going to check call, why not just lead out? Bet fold the turn. More chance of winning it. Oh, wow. Absolutely blessed. Problem is either going to go check, check, or bet fold. He's unlucky his opponent hasn't got like a little rat with the ace 4-5, because then he gets on. We know he's not calling the 9,000. Next case. Only Jan Peter can be in for 40,000 and back out of it in an hour. He's in front, he's sitting deep, and it's available. One big loser at the moment. I think he lost a lot of value in a couple of hands. It's not taking it away from him, he's a great player. But it hasn't been that swingy that I thought it would be today. I thought there'd be a lot more players in deeper, a lot of bigger pots. He's a lucky face, what can you say? Bojang raising up Kaiser's open. Kaiser just not getting involved. I think he's feeling the pain today. Can't win every day.
How about the one of Stalin?
They all want him.
Sometimes you're funny.
They tried to get a compulsory straddle to go. And it's not often you'll get a Frenchman cracking a joke. That's funny.
It took me 10 seconds to get it.
Kai Lin was the only player objecting to it. And it's his turn to straddle. And Thomas Bichon asked him about 200 straddle. Look at Jachtamann folding. Okay, a re-raise from the button, a 3-bet with 3, 4, 6, 7 double suited to get heads up with Kaiser. The odds won't be too different. Oh, 10-9, he's got a pair, backdoor clubs and an up and down end at the bottom. Oggy can win this with a bet. A gut shot for the bottom end. Got a flush draw that if he gets called is bad, but he can represent this kind of board. And you don't really want to get involved with bottom pair in the up and down with no flush draw. And Oggy, quite rightly, after 3-betting and taking control of the action, c-bets this flop and wins the pot.
Let's get it in.
Round of seven. Minus eins. Everybody except. Einer hat keinen Vertrag. Einer. Hat Vertrag woanders.
Oh yeah, thanks Michael. I just realised what that number meant.
I like how young
1978, I'm guessing that was the year you were born, so we must be the same age. I'm a 78 baby too, it's the best year. Small blind doesn't need to raise with king's one suit. Out of position.
Jan and Ronnie for sure.
Queen jack 8. He's got the king high flush draw. 9-10 for Oggy with the straight. Ten gives Hougaard the bigger straight. The bet 600, I think just a flat call. Yep. Yan's out the way, Kaiser's out the way. These guys are heads up.
A few years ago, right here. They voted up who has to leave.
If it comes to 10, I think he still gets on. They call that one a brick. Check. I mean, now you've got to know your opponent's on a draw. Price it accordingly. Go for like 1700, but I think he's going full pot. No, he's done it. 1800, I like the bet. Give your opponent a bit of a discount psychologically, give them a bad price to call. 2.2 to 1, it says. That's what the numbers underneath mean. So 28%, 2.2 to 1. And he's called. Any 10, any heart. And it's only the ace of hearts. That's the card he was praying for. Now he knows he's got the nuts. But I don't think he's going to get paid. You never know. Looks like he was on a draw. If he checks, there's certain players that would bet they're straight on the river, but a lot are just going to check behind. So unfortunately, I think you have to bet. You just have to maybe go for like what looks like a stopper bet to try and get paid like 2,500. $3,000, same, half pot. Just try and get something from your opponent. Looks like a stopper bet.
Yeah.
I think Oggy is folding. He's got the 10 of hearts in his hand. So it's either a complete bluff, the bear king, or the nuts, because the ace, the queen, the jack is on the board.
So you think that would be like always the game?
Solid fold from Oggy.
What is all these other guys in the English and Matt and all that? I don't, anyway, I don't know how to play it there, but.
So just had confirmation, I've popped out the room before to check with Jens. They're not going to be doing any streaming of the Dutch Poker Open because he's off to do the commentary in German for the EPT Monte Carlo. I don't speak German, except the odd word.
It's the worst service for food in the whole world. The worst fucking service for drinks or food.
Monte Carlo is the worst. It's not even the worst on the casino, it's even the worst in the hotels. Monte Carlo casino everywhere.
So bad. And that's what I read every time.
Set on top because you know.
They don't care about it.
But over there you are not welcome. But at least supposed to say thank you for coming over.
And you are friends. And you are friends. But at least you're not friends.
Yeah.
At least it's cheap.
He's just talking about Monaco.
Bad
the service is. Another drink. How cheap it is over there.
It's
like £10 for Coke. 15 euros for a sandwich.
I've been
not for the faint-hearted.
For 3-4 years, because I'm not. I don't like it there that much. What a game! A game to cover.
2 years ago was amazing.
Last year
was really good if you played really high.
Okay.
But only if you played really, really high. Yeah,
the 3-6 plus.
The 1500 was bad. The 2550 was pretty good. Okay. We played 5 card or 6 card. 2550 5 card was the best game.
You think we can play this
year? Sure. All the French guys are coming. Yeah, but
the nut flush draw for Jan Peter, who's now made a pair in the gut shot 5. Give him a straight.
The bigger games were really good, like 2-1, stuff like that.
400.
It was only one.
Yeah, it was one.
The ones it was 5100.
If he can make the bet, that's a great bet. He's got, as we spoke about earlier, the blockers. He's a 10% dog, and he's bet. What did he bet? He bet 3,000. Jan Peter doesn't mind a gamble. Problem is, if it comes to 5, what's he going to do? Check, call a pot size bet? He could be drawing, to nothing. He's called. He's come a 10.
Got a lot worse in the last couple of years as well, right?
Jan Peter is ahead. He's going to check.
Barcelona, I thought, was really good this year.
And it's so tough. If he got called on the turn, you've got to assume a player like Jan Peter is calling him on the river. So, unfortunately, you know you can't win. You've got a bit of showdown, I guess, if your opponent just had a draw. You can beat a lot of draws, but there's a lot of ace-high flush draws you're not going to beat. So you have to bet to win. But if he's called 3,000 on the turn, you've got to go for like 6K. Wow, Ognjen! Absolute respect to you, my friend. I didn't think you had the minerals.
Ognjen, how can I not win a hit against two like a hit against one? Not once.
He's very comfortable now. Now Jan Peter's just made that speech. How can I not hit against you? Ognjen's heart rate has just dropped back down. Because I promise you, he didn't like making that bet against Jan Peter. Who they probably would put more of a calling station in his category.
Why you have it always? And the kid,
you see his reputation, why do you always have it? Jan Peter wasting a bit of time. We know he's not calling. And hats off to Oggy. He knew the situation. He knew he had to bet. Come and show the bluff! Oh. Oi, oi! Stone cold bluff. Good when you're a bit of a tight player to show the odd bluff here and there. Because you think you might get paid off next time because you normally always got it. Yeah, and Peter, he's not tilted by
it. Game is on!
Walker.
Well played, Oggy.
Nice, Oggy, nice.
Well played, but if he has two
pairings. Exactly.
That's
possible. No, he would fold.
Next time,
the similar option to win a book is graphic.
You should write a book.
Best hand of the day for Oggy, that one. Takes a sip of water.
Du har bare chance til at være karte, Kæbes. Så er nøgen karte. Men det er karte, tror jeg. Ja.
Why would he bet pot if he had the straight? The reason that he'd bet the pot if he had the straight against a player like Jan Peter is, as he just said, if he had two pair, he might call. If he had, I can't remember the exact board, maybe there was a worse straight. If he had a set, he might call. Loads of situations where Jan Peter just calls.
I missed the chance.
He has been betting pot when he's got it, in fairness. I think he played well. Other players might not think, well, he wouldn't bet pot if he had the straight. Either way, you bet. Some players like to kind of make it look like a value bet and bet like 4.5K and then the player just can't fold a rag two pair against them. So he just went for the full pot. He went with it heart and soul and put the money in the middle. top set. Against Bojang is betting his second nut flush draw with an up and down. The money is going in. The flush draw is no good for Bojang. See the queen eye flush draw, easy fold. Right, let's get the money in. This is going to be the biggest pot of the night. They're probably going to run it twice. It's all in and a call.
I don't like to hear that.
I have a really, really, I have...
got a monster pot. 82% favourite.
Go down, please. You decide.
I like to go through it.
Heads. He's just basically got the up and down. I'd want to run it once or three times in this scenario. Running it twice, if he catches one. Wow, he's hit the first one hard. He needs it to pair up or a heart. There is the heart, the first pot. So yes, but well, one of his threes has gone now. So he needs a three or an eight. Oh, he hits instant service on the second one. Still a pair up. It's not to be. They've split the pot. 80% favorite running it twice. All that excitement. And they chop up a few things. I think the floor man's coming over to tell them it's the last few hands.
You get there twice.
If I'm an 80% favorite, I want to run it three times. Or once. They do it for. For variance, I'm trying to think of the word. Mr. B, if you're still listening, if you're still with us, Joe, it'll be done in about 15 minutes. Just going to grab some food and I'll give you a call.
That's why if nothing changed at the board, I might think about that.
Can you not have like 10 to a queen high flush draw?
I would have got that in too.
Yeah, I would have won two times.
Oh, he has plenty highs. I play very tight. You play very dead or good?
No, I play very tight. This one.
Very tight, okay. Maybe you can.
Yeah, Peter. Pumping. Pumping it up. Three bets to 900. Round two for these guys. This is why Oggy showed a bluff earlier. What a great flop. For all the players that folded. Now we get to see poker. It's check, check.
Is there anybody else? Against anybody else.
Come on, Oggy, find a bet. Very hard.
I mean, I know you
did open to 300. Jan Peter did three bet the button.
It's
not a great pot. Jan Peter is going to win this with a pair of nines. Turning his hand into a bluff if he bets.
We knew that before. I almost folded.
Yeah, you win with
25,
but then I still get it in.
Yeah, and you're still
winning. No, we'll probably run it twice at the 8 couple of the second time.
I would have felt better, though.
I don't think he's in wrong spot.
I only run it once on it. My set, you only can second once. You only have 1 hour of check.
That's a very good one.
Who writes this book?
It's in the same book from Nikki.
Chapter 2.
Nikki fehlt an der Tisch.
Zu wenig Stürmer. Nur Ronny und ich sind zu wenig.
I think Marco and Bruno might like
mean,
we are living in 36 hours.
Chinese game. It's early.
This year because they have like really full. Yeah. They have like 100 qualifiers for
spinning yours.
That's actually good for the
team. Okay, 15 minutes of action. Look at this, they've both got kings and sixes. You won't see that too often. Just been in the German booth where they've got a floor mat. A doormat for a Live Bourrine. Got a picture on. Queens, I like the 5-5-4-3 double suited. That is my kind of hand right there in position. Look at these hands. This is going to be action.
No.
Well, there's not going to be too much action with the kings and sixes because they can't improve. Diamonds or spades. Is that queen jack 10? No, jack 10. Jachtamann, I thought, would be favourite to win this pot. Because he'll bet it. He'll bet this turn. Jan Peter Jachtamann, favourite to win this hand, in my opinion. There is an up and down for Mads. He's checked for pot control. He's been checked all the way around on the flop, checked on the turn. Jan Peter will believe he's in front. But Hougaard beat him to it. Two 250 is going to get called by Queens with the up and down. Pretty sure.
Red and white, Danish dynamite. That's what they like. Red and white.
It is a call.
Danish championship.
The river is a diamond. Likely to be check. Hougaard will just check behind. Betting for value here, you only hope to get called by a queen eye flush. That's it. I like that check behind. A lot of players bet there, but there's no real value to bet it.
I cannot believe I had king 6-6-2.
Really?
I swear.
He's not lying.
Lucky me.
How could I win that hand?
I had king 6-6-2.
Can't have king 6-6-2. That's five cards.
That's right. Red and white. Yeah. Spanish dynamite.
Here we go.
So tell me, how is the song? I remember the song old times for the...
Well, actually, the way the song goes, these European Championships 92. Deutschland, Deutschland, alles ist vorbei.
Alles ist vorbei.
Halt.
Wir sind ohne Weiß, wir sind Finnisch.
Wir stehen
zusammen. Yeah, I remember that. Everybody learns Danish now, come on.
My favorite is the 92 Euro 92 song. Everybody in Denmark was singing it for 3 weeks. Deutschland, Deutschland, alles ist vorbei.
It was not our song.
It was just our song.
It was raising the baton.
Danish team win, yeah, okay.
Oh, you think? They were all on holiday.
That's what I mean.
All of them were over.
I mean, it was not only against Germany. They were surprisingly coming through.
So guys, last chance.
Good Dachkan. Flo, is Dachkan there? Can you call it?
Just drei Hände.
Time for the
so, the floorman has just announced it is the last three hands of the night. We're going to have an hour's break after that. We'll be back for No Limit Hold'em. So we've played. We'll be 4 hours. Biggest pot so far, €44,650. The lineup is confirmed. Tobias in seat number 5. Livbury in seat number 7, Quirinzek in seat 3, Igor in seat 2, Daniel in seat 1, SR in seat 6, Martin Cabril in 8, and Roman in seat 4. Looks like they're all buying in for 10,000. That game kicks off in an hour. We'll be here, we'll be live. Thank you very much, guys. Do my best. That's all you can do. Meanwhile, not too much going on in this coup. Two hands after this one. Tell the bosses that you like it. Send them a message. Get a blast in the kitchen, or did a fuse go? 7-8-9. 10-6 for Kai Lin. Just a gut shot 10. Pair the 8. He could get paid now. I would bet my straight. You've got to bet your straight there. You can bet fold. I mean, there's only 1,000 in the middle. Bet and try and get some value.
I don't know. I'd like to know what the outcome is going to say.
What he's going to say about keeping.
Yeah, I don't know if it's going to be again 25, 25, 50, 50, if there is a seat and leaving no limits on that.
It's not really a point for this game to keep on.
Well, what's the point to play 25, 75?
No.
I don't know. We should discuss about this.
How many hands?
Thomas wants to know what's going to happen, if the game's going to continue. Keep throwing the compliments in, why not? Nah. Who is going to win the last hand of the night? I am going to say...
No.
Mads. Mads in trap 8 is going to win the last hand.
I'm all on the song.
No, all it's the.
You pick a bean.
I'll pick a bean.
Okay.
Okay. You can't normal.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You can't normal. Do normal.
Me too. Yeah.
Ah, so.
So this pot's going to be quite small. I will check later on who has won the goodie bag. And more guesses for the evening session. I'm going to try and give two prizes away for the night session. While we're on break, you've heard the lineup, 8 players. First person with the correct answer. Who's going to be the first player to have been felted in the Hold'em game? Who's going to be the first? Don't really want to say to reload, because someone might lose 5k and reload. So the first player to get felted. Thomas Bojang has raised it up. Or bet, I mean. The pot.
I'm glad you showed me that, because otherwise I would later somebody say, and I would forget, I would get a surprise.
That's okay.
I said, what? I had a test here? Good, boss.
Kai Lin called him. If he's called, I'm guessing he plans on calling on this river.
Adds a chance to win in the turn.
Bojang cannot win this pot unless he bets. Kai Lin's not been getting too involved and he's only got 4k left, so you've got to put it all in. You've got to bet it all. Well, he just gave up with bottom pair. Very interesting.
Second
Neil Sweeting just sending us a message. Good to hear from you, sir. Hope you're well. Okay, last hand of the night.
Last hand.
Come on, the straddles. Double straddles. We haven't had one double straddle today. Maybe tomorrow. We'll see the lineup. I had Madden, but he's folded. Yeah, and Peter Jachtamann might want to win the last hand. We're back in an hour for the Hold'em. Tomorrow, 4 o'clock for the Pot Limit Omaha. Same time, same place, same voices, same viewers. Different players, maybe. Aces for Cao Ying, 3-bet. He just wants to get the money in, get out of it. Bojang calling. 4-6 jack, 2 diamonds. It's a gut shot for Bichon. Bojang, none of it. And Cao Lin is just going to bet pot.
You don't know, you haven't seen my gut.
Yeah. Well, nice game in the sense that it's a fun thing.
Yeah, yeah. I would like to play with my 13. Always trying to bluff in stupid situations.
See a lot of bluff. There's no bluffing in stupid situations.
That's going to be the end of it. I mean, there is a pair and a gut shot for Bojang, but can't imagine he wants to call. Just can't imagine. No vow. Cao Lin. He's not really a bluffer, even though he's betting out here thinking he's good. And he is good.
That's lucky.
Gives it up. Thomas will fold this hand. We conclude today's session. The winners and losers will be on the screen. We'll get the final counts. I can confirm the biggest pot was €44,650. I'll get it verified by the floor. And we will be back in 1 hour for No Limit Hold'em. Go and take the wife, give her a massage, and make sure she gives you one, I mean. Have something to eat, do whatever you've got to do, leave work and come back.
Pretty much, he's not really.
We'll see you in an hour.
Have a
night. I've been Paul Zimbler, I've enjoyed being here. Hope to see you tomorrow at 4 o'clock for more Omaha. But if you like the Hold'em, we'll see you in an hour.